We've got a few minutes yet before the umpire calls batter up, and that's a good time for you to get set behind a grand glass of Valentine Ale or beer. Yes, sir, it's time for those two B's, baseball and Valentine. That combination's so good that I'm suggesting you take a quick trip to the refrigerator for a bottle right now. Or if you're listening in there at your favorite tavern, don't just ask for an ale or a beer, but ask that man for Valentine Ale and Valentine Beer. And now you're set for a swell afternoon of baseball and Valentine. The umpires met early, broke up with managers Earl Combs representing the Red Sox. Joe McCarthy doesn't come out. Single is out there. Of course, they can't start this ball game to 2:05. And now the Yankees will be out of their dugout and out in the field. There they go. Let's quickly run down the lineups now, because we don't have much time. DiMaggio, center field, leading off for the Red Sox. Teske playing third, batting number two. Williams in left field, hitting number three. Vern Stevens, the cleanup man. Our national anthem, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd settles back down again. Bobby Doerr batting number five for the Red Sox at second base. Al Zarrilla will be in right field. Billy Goodman at first base. Bertie Tebbets catching. Alice Kinder, 23 wins, 5 loss for the right-handed pitching. For the Yankees, Rizzuto at short. Henrik at first. Barra the catcher. DiMaggio center field. Lindell left field. Johnson at third base. Mapes in right field. Coleman, the second baseman, and Vic Rashi, with a record of 20 wins, 10 losses, will carry the Yankee hope into the ballgame this afternoon. So Vic Rashi has already moved out there to the mound, and we're just about ready to go here now for this big one. And before we take the air, I just want to say to Mel Allen that it's been a great thrill being associated with the Yankees this year. And Mel, it's been wonderful working with you. You're a grand guy. You've done a great job this year. Been a fine season. So you're ready to go now, Mel, and take over.
Hello there, everybody. Well, we started back in March preparing for the Pennant campaign, and when it began back in April, there were those who didn't know what was going to happen. Nobody did. There were those who didn't give the Yankees a chance to finish higher than third, and third on down. And when the smoke of battle has cleared today, it may be that they have finished second. It may be that they have finished first. But let me say this. We have had occasion to root for the Yankees during the course of this year, a very courageous team. But today, against another great ball club, the Boston Red Sox, we're going to give this broadcast a treatment that we feel both teams deserve. An equal treatment all the way through, as if it were a World Series. And the first pitch of the ball game, the Dom DiMaggio is in there for a call strike. So cast aside, if you will, permit us to cast aside our partisan feelings to bring the broadcast the most important of the year in the American League. And the pitch swung on a ground ball, hit the Henrik. He's up with it. Out runs. Down to first is one away. Meant to say outran Dom to first. Dom DiMaggio grounded out to Henrik unassisted. Dom is hitting at 309. Here's Johnny Pesky stepping in. Newcomb going for Brooklyn. Meyer for Philadelphia. Here's the pitch. strike called over the inside corner. They'll be roaring on every pitch today. You got Lindell in left, DiMaggio in center, Mason right. Billy Johnson in close at third in the event of the bunt. Pesky guarding that plate. Vic Crashy comes in with his pitch outside, ball one. You got Rosito at short in halfway, four strides to the left of second. He's picking up a pebble. Ted Williams on deck. Jerry Coleman, four strides to the right of second. Henrik Deep guarding the line. The outfield shaded slightly toward left. The 1-1 pitch to Johnny Pesky. Swung on a miss. Strike two. One ball, two strikes to count. Vic Rashi on the hill for Yankees. Ellis Kinder on the firing line for the Red Sox. This is it. It's only, the only tough part about it all is that one of these two teams has to lose. Now the 1-2 pitch on its way to Pesky. Here it is, swung on, fouled off to the left of the plate onto the screen. And this magnificent crowd will be roaring on every pitch if it's a close ball game. Sometimes these kind of games, the ones that you figured are going to be really close all the way, turn out to be routs. As Cleveland beat the Red Sox almost a year ago tomorrow, in a playoff game. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on, loop foul, back of third, out of play. The ball going into the photographer's box just below the mezzanine. The Dodgers and Phils both scoreless in the first inning. St. Louis at Chicago, not yet underway. We'll keep you posted on the progress of all other ball games that are important today, as well as those that are just being played out. Rashi's 1-2 pitch. Curve, just high, ball two, 2-2. Curve was over, but high. Vic working very carefully on Pesky. Johnny hitting it 308. He's been a key factor in the rise of the Red Sox. Now Rashi's 2-2 pitch. Swung on, fouled back to the screen. Pesky still manages to get a piece of it. Everybody that each team has will be in there today if they need them. Two balls, two strikes, one out, top of the first inning. Johnson's backed up at third with two strikes on Pesky. Big Cal Hubbard calling balls and strikes. Rashi getting the sign. Now he starts to wind up. Around comes the right arm. The 2-2 pitch is swung on. There's a drive out to left field. Lindell's out there, and Johnny's got it. And now to bat comes Ted Williams, hitting at 344. Big Ted digs in. The shift is on with Coleman out on the grass and right. Rizzuto on the first base side to second. Here's your pitch. Just outside. Ball one. Very close to the outside corner. Ty Tyler coaching at third. Earl Combs at first. Johnson shades his eyes from the sun to see how it is. He's 20 feet off the third baseline. Outfield deep. Round toward right. Here's your pitch. Williams takes the curve low. Ball two. Two balls, no strikes to count on Ted. He'll be slashing for distance if he gets one he likes. Two outs, top of the first inning. All right, Rashi's pitch. Low, ball three. Every one of those pitches has been right around the plate. Just missing corners, and the last one was just below the knees. Buster Stevens is on deck. Now the 3-0 pitch. Inside, ball four, Williams walks, and that brings up Stevens. Buster hitting at 292. Outfield swings around toward left. Billy Johnson goes back deep at third, 3 feet off the line. Bill Rizzuto back deep over toward the gap. Coleman stride to the right of second. Henrik holding against Williams. Rashi takes the stretch, checks Ted. There's a move to first base, not in time. Little slug is up. Rashi stretches. Here's the pitch. Swung on, fouled off to the right of the plate, out of play. Strike one. Looks like Stevens was hitting that ball or trying to hit it to right field. Cleanup man for the Red Sox is in there. Top of the first inning. Left field is going to be rough on both Lindell and Williams today. Left field this time of year, the sun field, is murderous. One strike to count on Burns Stevens. Williams moves off first, a stretch by Ranchi. Here's the pitch. Stevens on a curve takes inside. Slow curve, ball one, one and one. Bobby Doerr is on deck. One ball, one strike, two outs. Mick again ready. Williams will believe. Henry Coley. Now the pitch. Curve is inside again for ball two. Now Henry walks over to say something to Rashi. A 2-1 count on Buckley. Mick knows he's got a dangerous hitter up there. Takes his stretch. Williams with the lead. Now the pitch. Swung on. It's a high pop-up. Out around second base. Jerry Coleman's under it. Williams running. And Jerry makes the catch. Right-hander swoops down low into the windup. First pitch. Strike one call. Fastball over the inside corner. Kinder's beaten the Yankees four times this year. They haven't beat him at all. The right-hander throws. Rizzuto takes outside for a ball as he bluffed a bunt. Bertie Tebbets was ready to move. So was Pesky. You got Williams in left. Dom DiMaggio in center. Al Zarilla in right. Pesky third. What was that sign they were carrying? Pennant bound or derailed the limited or something. The 1-1 pitch to the scooter. Low outside for ball two. Pesky at third, Stephen short, Doerr second. Billy Goodman first, Buddy Tebbets catching. Frank Cossetti coaching at third and Bill Dickey at first. Last half of the first inning of the payoff game of the 1949 American League pennant race that has been a sizzler these last few weeks. Here's your pitch. Swung on, fouled back just to the left of our boot. Hit the steel girder and bounces back downstairs. Kinder. He is a magnificent pitcher. Coming into his own this year, 36-year-old right-hander. He lost a lot of time when he was in service. Red Sox got him from the Browns. He won 10 games to Boston last year, and this year has lost him into a 23-game winner. The 2-2 pitch to the scooter. Outside, ball three. So Little Phil's got the count run out to 3-2. Kinder starts the windup. He aims the ball over the plate, and it is swung on line to around the left field line, and it's in there for a base hit. Bounces off into the corner. Phil goes for two. The ball gets away from Ted. Phil's going to go for three. Ted up for the ball. The throw to third. Not in time. So three base hit for the scooter. Rizzuto triples into the left field corner. The ball carried away from Williams and enabled Phil to make the triple instead of the double. And here's Tommy Henry hitting at 286. Kinder throws. Swung on and missed. Strike one. Kinder gave him that screwball. The Dodgers failed to score in the top of the second inning. Nothing, nothing. Philadelphia batting last the second. All right, Kinder into the windup. In comes the pitch. Henry swings, sends a ground ball out toward second. Rizzuto will score. Doerr up for the ball. Throws to Goodman. 1-0 New York. Tommy Henry grounded out. Doerr to Goodman. And there's one away. Nobody on. One run in as Henry gets his 84th RBI of the year. Now the batter is Yogi Berra. Berra batting at 277. 1-0 New York. Ellis Kinder comes in with a pitch, swung on, fouled off of the left of the plate, strike one. Yogi was trying to hit that one over the head of Johnny Pesky, who's in close at third. Kinder works, got a good fastball curve and a good screwball. Mixes them up nicely. The right-hander delivers to Barra. Swung on, the ground ball hit the second. Bobby Doerr scoops it up, throws to Billy Goodman. They're two away. And up comes Joe DiMaggio. Joe hitting at 347. Barra was batting at 277 before he went out. So the option is to round four, two down. And Kinder going to work on the clipper. Here it is. Just outside, ball one. Johnny Lindell is on deck. Johnny Pesky, fairly deep near the third baseline. Stevens into the hole. Doerr over towards second. The pitch, right over for a call strike. One and one. Looked like a slider. Billy Goodman in halfway at first. Doesn't feed off the line. A lot of room in the right field corner. The 1-1 pitch. Swing on and missed. Strike two. He foul tipped it, and the ball hit Bertie Tebbets just above the mitt on the wrist. He's all right. Joe went for a low fastball and foul tipped it. And it's a 1-2 count on him. 1-0 to score. Favor the Yankees. First inning. Rizzuto scored his 111th run of the year. All right, Kinder all set. Give Joe some breaking stuff, most likely. The 1-2 pitch is just outside. Curve, ball 2-2. Cardinals and Cubs not yet underway. Philadelphia batting the last of the second inning. No score with Brooklyn. Two balls, two strikes. And the 2-2 pitch. Swung on, fouled off to the right of the plate, out of play, into the upper deck. This is an enthusiastic crowd, as you would well expect, as was yesterday's. They'll be roaring almost on every pitch, every situation. This is what these two ball clubs have battled for all year, and the prize will go to the one or the other. They both are deserving. The 2-2 pitch. Swung on, fouled off to the left of the plate, out of play. You know, when you come right down to it, that is always the saddest part of any great athletic contest between two great ball clubs, and that is that one must lose. But whatever happens here today, the winner should be proud and the loser just as proud. Ellis Kinder's 2-2 pitch to Joe. Swung on, there's a fly ball to right field. Al Zarrillo racing over, he may get to it, still running hard, can't do it. Joe's going to go for two, and Zarrillo falls down, and Joe will go for three. Zarrillo throws on in, DiMaggio goes to third. It's a triple for Joe DiMaggio. His sixth of the year. And the batter is Johnny Lindell. A two-out triple, one that could be wasted unless Lindell delivered. Lindell, hitting at 239, steps in. Two men out, DiMaggio on third. Ellis Kinder throws to Lindell. Outside, ball one. Billy Johnson's on deck. Now the right-hander throws. Lindell swings and fouls it off of the left of the plate. He's off stride as he went for a breaking pitch. One ball, one strike, two outs. Last half of the first inning, 1-0 in favor of the Yankees. Rizzuto opened with a triple. Scored on Henrik's infield out. And then after Barra had grounded out, DiMaggio triples. So Lindell is up with a 1-1 count and two down. And Ellis Kinder into the windup throws, and Lindell takes low, ball two, 2-1. Howie Paulette going for the Cardinals today, and Schmidt for the Cubs. Johnny Schmidt against Howie Paulette. They're warming up. Two balls, one strike on Lindell. DiMaggio comes up the line. Kinder delivers. Lindell takes high, ball three. Rain won the count on Johnny. Pesky deep at third. Don't think Lindell will be doing it, but it's a great spot to bunt. Two out, not looking for it, 3-1, pesky deep. Of course, you'd have to get it perfectly placed to get the run in. Three balls, one strike, two outs. Kinder into the windup. In comes the pitch. Swung on, popped up into the air, coming back behind the plate. Tebbets after the ball. He cannot get to it. Out of play. And you got a full count on Lindell. 3-2. DeMange is breathing quite hard there at third base. He's still weak from his ordeal and his battle against virus pneumonia, near pneumonia. Running around those bases took a lot out of him. You tell, you're watching even. Joe McCarthy comes to the edge of the Red Sox dugout now as Kinder starts to wind up for the playoff pitch. Here it is. Lindell swings and grounds it foul to the left of the plate down the third baseline. At the end of two innings, Brooklyn and Philadelphia, nothing and nothing. Newcomb going against Meyer. Russ Meyer and Don Newcomb. Paulette and Schmitz are warming up out in Chicago. That game will be underway in a few minutes. Last half the first inning at Yankee Stadium, two down, 3-2 on Lindell. The match on third, one run in. The windup, here's the payoff pitch, and Lindell takes ball four outside. That brings to the plate Billy Johnson, hitting a 247. So you have Lindell on first, DiMaggio on third. Two outs, one run in. Last the first inning, 1-0, New York. Kinder checks with Tebbets. Outfield for Johnson. Slightly toward right and center and right, straight away and left. Here's the pitch. Swung on a ground ball foul down the third baseline. Crissetti misses it. Coaching there at third. Bill Summers goes over. Got six umpires again today. Cal Hubbard calling balls and strikes. Eddie Rommel umpiring at first base. Charlie Berry at second. Bill Summers at third. And incidentally, Bill Summers did a magnificent job back of the plate yesterday, as did the other umpire from their decision. Jim Honeychick umpiring down the left field line. Ed Hurley down the right field line. One strike on Johnson, stretched by Kinder. Runners off first and third. The pitch, low outside for a ball, 1-1. One ball, one strike. Kinder working very carefully in a bit of a spot. DiMaggio moves off third, Lindell off first, two down. Now we're ready for the 1-1 pitch. Here it is, outside, ball two, 2-1. Cliff Mapes in the batter's circle. Billy Johnson steps out of the batter's box for a moment. Now he's back in. It's a 2-1 count on Bill. The big hole in the outfield is in left center. Brady Tebbets comes back behind the plate. I don't know whether Casey Stengel now will have Johnny Lindell running with this pitch. It's a 3-1 count on Bill. A lot of times it's a perfect spot to hit and run. But, of course, DiMaggio will play it safe. He's not forced. And could be Lindell played safe with only a 3-1 count in the event Billy would swing and miss. But we'll see the stretch. There it goes, Lindell. The pitcher swung on. A ground ball back through the middle. Bobby Dorr up with the ball. Throws to first base in time. And there was a situation that caused by Lindell's breaking for second, it brought Bobby Dorr over to cover. And had he not had to break to cover, that ball might have gone through the middle. That is, might have gone right on through into center. So Kinder pitches himself out of the situation. One run for New York, two hits, no errors for the Red Sox. And two men left on for New York. So at the end of one inning, Yanks won, Red Sox nothing. It'll be Bobby Dorr, Al Zarrilla and Billy Goodman coming up in the top of the second for the Red Sox. And on this Ballantyne Ale and Beer broadcast, we pause briefly for station identification. Broadcast is reaching you over the radio facilities of WINS New York, 1010 on your dial. Having just a quick look at the Ballantyne three-ring scoreboard in the American League, White for the White Sox. Garver started for the Browns. Ostrowski and Fannin have come on in relief. That's in the second and third innings. No score then at two. The only game underway yet in the American League. Bissey against White is going to be the pitcher of Philadelphia at Washington. Over in the National League, Fox and Chambers, Cincinnati at Pittsburgh, 2-1 Pirates, last the seventh. Paulette going for the Cardinals. Schmitz for the Cubs, just about to get started. Newcomb for the Dodgers. Meyer for the Phils. No score at the end of two. All right, here's Bobby Doerr, batting at 309. Vic Rashi throws, swung on, foul back to the screen, strike one. The Giants have Kennedy going, and the Braves spawn. No score at the end of two in that game. Bobby Doerr, right-hand hitter, leading off top of the second. 1-0, New York. Rashi ready. The right-hander delivers. Doerr takes strike two call over the inside corner. Fastball nicked that inside corner just above the knees. The outfield for Doerr toward left and center and left, almost straight away and right. Although, no, I'll take that back. Makes it more over toward right center. Johnson deep at third. Now the two-strike pitch. Curve is outside. Ball one. Sidearm curve. 1-2. Kai Kyler coaching at third, and Earl Combs at first. Al Zarilla's on deck. Bobby Doerr standing away from that plate, knees bent, open stance. Bat cocked up off his right ear, leaning slightly from the waist. Vic Rashi delivers. The pitch is a curve that just outside for ball two. 2-2. That was the one that Vic wanted to get in there for the strike zone, hoping to get Bobby to go for it. Now with a count 2-2, Vic's got to decide what to do with the pitch, and here it comes. Bobby Doerr is set, and the delivery swung on, drilled into right field. There's Cliff Mace out there waiting, and Cliff takes it for the out. Doerr hit a humpback liner out to Mace in right field. One down, and up comes Al Zarilla. Zarilla bats him left-handed, hitting at 280. You know, we've been so full of tension all year long, that honest to goodness, today I'm just forgetting about everything. I mean, whatever happens, something's got to happen today. So, this is the way it's going to be. Here's the pitch. Just outside, ball one. One ball, no strikes. The Yankees have done an out-of-this-world job this year. The Red Sox have just been magnificent. Here's the pitch. Strike, one call, fastball to the outside corner. Any ball club that can make up 12 games from July 4th to now, and actually at one point they went ahead by one game, up until yesterday they had made up 13 game deficit. You've got to be good to do that. The 1-1 pitch, Al Zarilla swings into bounder out over the head of Rashi, out to short. Rizzuto has it, throws over to Henrik, two away. Two up and two down, the batter now is Billy Goodman. Goodman hitting at 298. Top of the second inning. Yankees one. Red Sox nothing. Joe DiMaggio moves over into left center for Goodman, who slices. They give him the right field line. Here's the pitch. Swung on, loop foul, back to third, out of play, into the upper deck, strike one. Cardinals and Cubs are starting now at Wrigley Field. Paulette and Rice against Schmidt and Owen. One strike on Billy Goodman. Billy Johnson's in close at third, 5-6 feet off the line. Rizzuto in halfway at short, four strides to the left of second. Coleman four strides to the right of second. Henrik on top of the line. The pitch outside. Ball one, 1-1. Big hole in the outfield is in right center and between Mace and the right field line. Although Goodman's a left-hand hitter, they don't play him to pull too sharply. Lindell not too deep in left, over toward the left field line. Vic Rashi's 1-1 pitch on its way. Goodman takes inside around the letters for ball two. 2-1. Buddy Tebbets on deck. Buddy somehow doesn't like to stand on the batter's circle. He's off behind it. Two balls, one strike. Rashi going to work. Billy Goodman set. Just outside for ball three. 3-1 count now. All I never saw so many wires. Telegrams had flooded our office here yesterday for both the Yankees, the Red Sox, for us, for everybody. The 3-1 pitch. Strike two call. Pumped a fast one through there. So it's a full count. 3-2 on Goodman. Two down. Top of the second inning. Nobody on. Yankees leading 1-0. And Rashie's payoff pitch on its way. Just outside for ball four, and Goodman walks. And that brings up Bertie Tebbets. That's the second base on balls given up by Rashie. Williams drew base on balls in the first inning. And Tebbets steps in. Bertie hitting at 267. He's a money ball player. He's an old pro. Outfield for Bertie. Almost straight away. Rashie has a stretch. Checks Goodman. There he goes. The pitch is swung on a miss. There's a throw down to Coleman. High, and it's a stolen base for Goodman. They had him going. The Red Sox playing daring baseball now. Of course, it's a sealed situation. And Goodman got the jump. He stole second base. That's his second steal of the year. It evidently was a hit-and-run play because Bertie swung and missed. Sometimes, though, when a batter sees a pitch in there for a strike, he'll swing at it anyway to nettle the catcher. So Goodman's in scoring position with a stolen base, two down here in the second inning. One strike on Bertie Tebbets. And Rashie now ready to go. Takes a stretch. Here's the pitch. It's a pass ball. It gets away from Barrett. Goodman may try to come all the way. No, he goes back to third. That ball got away from Yogi. Squared it between his legs. Goodman took a big turn around third. Came up about 15 feet toward the plate and then went back. So the count on Tebbets, one ball, one strike. It's a pass ball charged to Berra. A pass ball. 1-0 favor the Yankees, top of the second inning. A walk, a stolen base, and a pass ball has gotten Goodman to third. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swung on as a looper out back of second. Coleman out there under it. And he's got it. No runs. No hits. No errors. One left on. And the score at the end of an inning and a half. The Yankees won. The Red Sox nothing. Fans, of course, you know there are a lot of many special words and phrases we use during the course of the season when we talk baseball. Phrase like top of the order. What's it mean? Well, first batter in the lineup, right? That's what we mean when we talk about the top of the order. Now, here's the phrase to use when you want to order a little something that's tops and refreshment. And listen close to this one. Ballantine beer. That's right. Just say, Ballantine beer, please. And a moment later, there's a golden glass of sparkling beer topped with a thick collar of creamy white foam right in front of you, just waiting for you to take that first thirst-quenching drink. Mm-hmm. You know, that famous three-ring trademark tells you why Ballantine's always so good. First ring stands for purity, the second for body, the third for flavor. Purity, body, and flavor in every glass of Ballantine beer. So whenever you're thirsty, look for the three rings, call for Ballantine beer. Roberts is going in to pitch for the Phils in the third. The Dodgers must be doing something. Here's Cliff Mapes up for the Yankees. Inside is Kinder's first pitch around the knees. Ball one. Mapes back from left-handed. Hitting at 245. Kinder throws. Swung on to ground ball. Hit out to Bobby Doerr. He's up with it. Throws over to Goodman. One away. And Doerr's been busy. Kinder's been making the Yanks go for that pitch of his that takes off. He's been pulling him down, hitting him down toward Bobby Doerr. That's four chances he's had. In other words, he has thrown out every Yankee who's gone out so far in the ballgame. Now Jerry Coleman steps in.
Coleman grounds out. Pitcher to first base.
Rasher bats him right-handed. Two men down, last to second, 1-0. Fair of New York. Ellis Kendrick comes in with his pitch, and it's over for a call strike. Fastball just above the knees. The Chicago Cubs are batting in the last half of the first inning. Cards fail to score in the top of the first. The one-strike pitch, Rashi takes outside and low, ball one. Count even up at 1-1. The outfield for a big straightaway. They respect him to the extent that if he should get a hold of one, he knows that he can drive it far, and so it's pretty deep. Fairly deep for a pitcher. Rashi hitting at 163. Swings and sends a ground ball back through the middle. Stevens out back to back, takes it a nice hop, flips over to Goodman in time. Nice play by Burns. No runs for the Yankees, no hits, no errors for the Red Sox, and nobody left on for New York. The score at the end of two innings of play, 1-0. With Phil Rizzuto having opened with a triple and having scored on Hendricks infield out. A two-out triple by DiMaggio was wasted along with a follow-up base-on ball for Lindell as Johnson grounded out to Bobby Doerr. I'd like to take just this moment while Rash is going out the hill so that I don't forget it later. I'd like to thank everybody here at Yankee Stadium outside of the bosses, and we always are able to say that to them. They know it. But we would like to pay tribute to a group of folks who do tremendous work year-round here at the stadium. Such folks as the supervisors in charge of all maintenance, Jim Regan and Jim Thompson, and the special police with Lieutenant Emil Sardinelli. The Dodgers got five runs in the top of the third inning to lead the Phils 5-0, and looks like they've got that kind of showed up there. Five runs for the Dodgers in the top of the third. Special police, Emil Sardinelli, and the chief of the ushers, Eddie Coyle, who does a great job. The foreman of maintenance, Jim Murphy. Foreman of cleaning, Arthur Campana. The foreman of the ground crew, Walter Owens. And our love and kisses to the switchboard operators, Ruth Bayline and Alice Dawson. All right, Ellis Kinder up, takes the pitch in there for a call strike. We go to the top of the third. Kinder hitting at 133. He's fairly a good sticker for a pitcher. Rashi sidearms him and in there for call strike two. Yeah, there are two girls that stay at that switchboard, and everybody else says, is there a game? Are there tickets? And they just work without a let-up for hours on end. Ruth Bayline and Alice Dawson, a love to them. The two-strike pitch, swung on, fouled back to the screen. Count holds, 0-2. On deck is Don DiMaggio as we go to the top of the order. And then Johnny Pesky. Top of the third inning, Yankees 1, the Red Sox nothing. Into the batter. Outfield straight away. Rashi going to work. In comes the pitch. Kinder takes just outside for a ball. 1-2. Just missed the corner. Big Cal Hubbard doing a fine job. And got a tough job. Big Betsy sign. Into the windup, round comes the arm, and the pitch, curve is swung on, top foul, out of play, behind the plate, slow curve. This broadcast, the broadcast portion of this combined broadcast and telecast is going around the world through the facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Heard by shortwave by our troops, boys and girls in service, wherever they may be. Now the 1-2 delivery on its way to Ellis Kinder. Swung on and missed, strike three. First strikeout for Rashi. And now Don DiMaggio steps up, hitting a 309. Grounded out to Hendrick in the first inning. Score, Yankees 1, Red Sox nothing, top of the third. sold a million tickets for this ball game. They had room for him. Johnson in close at third to pitch. Swung on, fouled off at the right of the plate, out of play. Strike one. Rashi came in on the fist with the fastball. The Yankees in the dugout, tense. Everybody is. Kurt's got one eye on the ball game, another eye on that ticker, because we want to give you, it's as fast as we get it, what occurs, St. Louis at Chicago and in the Brooklyn-Philadelphia game. Dodgers leading 5-0, Phil's batting last to third. Cardinals fail to score in the top of the first inning. Here's the pitch, swung on, a bouncer hit out to short, two hops to Rizzuto, up with it, throws over to Henrik, in time, two away. Two up and two down, now you've got Johnny Pesky, hitting a 308. Loop a fly to Lindell in the first inning, and you've got Ted Williams on deck. Short's always a big man in anybody's scheme of things when you're working against Boston, particularly with two down to work hard on Pesky, with Williams coming up. Here's the pitch. Curve in there for a call strike. Sidearm curve. There's not a man alive that wears a baseball uniform that doesn't respect the power and the magic and the bat of Williams. For that matter, Johnny Pesky, who's got 185 hits this year. Now the pitch. Just outside for a ball, one and one. Bill Johnson's in close at third in the event Johnny tries to bunt. Frequently, Johnny will try to drag one or bunt one to get on with two down ahead of Williams. Always represents a potential two if he gets on. Now the 1-1 pitch to Pesky. High outside, ball two, 2-1. He's a rugged little fellow to pitch to because he hits the ball where it's pitched. In other words, he'll pull him to right field, or he'll hit him to right center, straightaway center, left center, down the third baseline, through the middle, between third and short. He hits him anywhere, and that's why he's kind of rough to pitch to. The 2-1 delivery. Outside for ball three. One to nothing, New York, top of the third inning, two down. And the 3-1 pitch on its way now to Johnny Pesky. Strike two called. Fastball poured through there. See Bertie Tebbit on the top step of the Red Sox dugout, closely watching Rashi for any tip-off on a pitch or something. Now the payoff pitch on its way to Pesky. It's swung on, hit the line drive, grabbed by Rashi for the out. Robbed him of a base hit. That was a vicious line drive right back through the middle. That's a base hit 999 times out of 1,000. Rashi ducked low, stuck his glove up off his left ear, and the ball struck by him for the out. You know, ball players say that's when you've got horseshoes in your glove, when you grab those kinds. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. And the score at the end of 2.5 innings, the Yankees 1, the Red Sox nothing. Well, Kirk, if your heart will just ease up for a little while, how about a nice word?
Well, let's hope so. Folks, are you enjoying the game? Well, let me tell you how you'll enjoy it even more with a delicious glass of Ballantine Ale or beer there at your elbow. That's right, a glass of Ballantine Ale or beer with a foamy whitehead riding on top. Does that sound good? Well, then how about getting a bottle out of the refrigerator? Now, if you're following the game at your favorite tavern, don't just ask for an ale or a beer, will you? Make it a point to ask that man for Ballantine. That's right, Ballantine Ale, Ballantine Beer.
Last half of the third inning, top of the Yankee order. Phil Rizzuto led off the first inning with a triple and scored on an infield out for the lone run of the game, hitting at 276. Kinder delivers outside, ball one. One ball, no strikes. Johnny Pesky's in close at third. The outfield swung around toward left. They give Phil all the room in the world in left center. Kinder pitches. Rizzuto takes low, ball two. Joe McCarthy evidently told Williams to get further over toward that left field line. Now, Dom DiMaggio is almost straightaway center, and Williams is no more than 20 feet off the left field line, so there's a big gap in left center. The 2-0 pitch. Strike one called. Kinder's fastball takes off sideways. That one was aimed toward the outside corner and broke away, but still had plenty of the plate. A 2-1 count on the scooter. Ellis Kinder, a great competitor, a game guy, delivers his 2-1 pitch, and it's outside for ball three. The Chicago Cubs did not score in the first inning, and at the end of one inning, Cardinals nothing, Cubs nothing. Philadelphia still batting in the last of the third. The Dodgers came up with five in the top of the third, and all they have to do is win. They've got the pennant, regardless of what the Cardinals do. Kinder ready for that 3-1 pitch. He aims it over the plate, fires, and it is in there for call strike two. Right-hander figured Phil to be taken, but all he had on it. Blue balls, two strikes. Henrik on deck. And now Kinder gets himself poised for the payoff pitch. Testing near that third baseline, back up a bit. The windup, the 3-2 pitch. Swung on, hit foul down the right field line, going out of play in the lower stand. One guy wanted to be out here today, he works downstairs. We go along paying our tributes, the guys who work hard. Joe Marine, supervisor of tickets here. He's home in bed with a grip. A 3-2 pitch. Swung on, foul off again by Phil, out of play, to the right of the plate. Mr. Will Harridge, president of the American League, is out here today. He has come on, of course, for the opening of the World Series, and we're trying to find out today whether it'll be played here or in Boston. It'll open in the American League town this year. Once again, Kinder set for his payoff pitch, and it is swung on and pops up into the air, off to the right of the plate, Stebbins off of the mask, under it, and Birdie's got it. Mr. Kinder has really been rough and tough. Barrett takes a strike over that outside corner. A pitcher's effectiveness comes from confidence. When he suddenly realizes he's got the touch, then he does not worry. It's when he's a little bit worried when he's missing, he's a little afraid and pressures, but when he finds he's got the touch, he's free and easy and fired. Barrett takes outside for a ball, 1-1. 1-0 ball game. Joe DiMaggio's on deck. Two down. Last the third inning. Kinder delivers. Barra swings and lets the fly ball serving foul back to third. That's Gaffney. He can't get it. It's out of play. 1-2 to count on Yogi. Barra hitting at 277. Tossed out by Bobby Doerr in the first inning. Trying so hard to be calm. Here's your pitch. Yogi swings and fouls it off the left of the plate. He went for a bad pitch. Zach Taylor of the Browns is doing something funny today in his ball game with Chicago. We'll tell you about it in a minute. The 1-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. No run, no hit, no error. Somebody left on, and Ellis Kinder has now retired 7 men in a row. And the score's down to 3 innings, 1-0 in favor of New York. Looking at the Valentine 3-ring scoreboard in the American League, a doubleheader. Chicago at St. Louis, the first game. White going for the White Sox. 1-1, the score's down to 4 innings. And here's what Zach Taylor is doing. He's pitching a different batter, a different pitcher every inning today. Started Garber, brought Ostrowski on in the second. Fannin pitched the third. Berrick pitched the fourth. Carl Drews is now working the fifth. We're going to give everybody an opportunity. Cleveland at Detroit, Lemon is to go against Truck. And at Washington, Brissy for the A's and White for the Senators. 1-0, Washington down at 2. In the National League, 2 games at Pittsburgh. The score is 2-2, last the eighth inning. And no, the Pirates came up with two now in the last of the eighth and lead 4-2. Chambers for the Pirates. Fox started for Cincinnati. Blackwell came on the eighth. Cooper home run in the eighth inning. And at Chicago, Howie Paulette going for the Cardinals. Johnny Schmidt for the Cubs. No score at the end of one inning. Newcomb going for the Dodgers. Meyer started for the Phils. Robertson in the third. Thompson come on in the fourth. 5-0 Brooklyn, 10-3. Kennedy for the Giants. Spahn for the Braves. 1-0 Boston, 10-4. And now we go to the top of the fourth inning. 1-0, New York, and the batter is Ted Williams. Williams leading off. Stevens and Dorr to follow. Here's the pitch. Williams swings, fouls it off upstairs. Out of play. As Ted, anticipating that inside pitch on the fifth, pulled away and tried to pull it deep. You've got Rizzuto with the shift on. Two strides to the right at second. Coleman out on the grass in short right with Hendricks deep on top of the first baseline. Johnson, the only infielder between third and second, and 20 feet off third baseline. Williams walks in the first inning. Dead hitting at 344. Mick crashes into the windup. Around comes the arm. The pitch swung on, grounded foul off to the right of the plate. Into the Yankee dugout. And it's a two-strike count. Buster Stevens is on deck. Two strikes to count on Williams. Top half of the fourth inning. Yanks 1, Red Sox nothing. Big Vic gets his sign. He's ready. So is Williams. And the pitch. Just inside for the ball. The curve. 1-2. Oh, man. I wish it was spring training. It was all bent over then. It's starting out fresh. Here's the pitch. Williams swings and grounds one out toward Rizzuto. He's up with it. Throws over to Hendrick in time. Rizzuto caught that one at second base. It's two strides to the right of second. So the shift that time worked. Now you've got Buster Stevens stepping in, batting at 292. Stevens popped out in the first inning to Jerry Coleman. Bobby Doerr's on deck. Outfield shifts around toward left. Vic Ratchet comes in with a pitch, and it is just off the outside corner. Ball one. Just missed. Rashi throws, Stevens swings and misses, strike one. He was going for all the marbles. In the little World Series that's being played at the end of six innings, and then in seven innings, Indianapolis leads Montreal 5-1. Lent going against King. Lee came in for King of Montreal in third inning. The 1-1 delivery, just outside the ball, 2-1. Baltimore 14, Buffalo 7, end of the first half in an All-American Conference game. Los Angeles Dons nothing, Cleveland nothing, end of the first period. Now the 2-1 pitch to Stevens on its way. Buster swings and rams one out to short. Rizzuto is right up with it. Fires over to Hendrick, and it's in time. You know what almost happened there? Rizzuto, for a split second, started to flip that ball to Johnson and let Johnson fire to first because Phil had to go over to his right in behind Bill, but he saw he had a chance to get Stevens. Johnson got a much stronger arm. So a two down upset Bobby Doerr. Fly to right field in the second inning. Doerr hitting 309. Here's the pitch. Way outside, gets away from Yogi. Ball one. The sidearm fastball meant to negotiate contact with the outside corner, but it didn't. Dodgers fail to score in the top of the fourth inning. They lead Philadelphia 5-0. They maintain that lead. They're in. Pittsburgh beat Cincinnati 4-2 first game. 1-0 New York, fourth inning, two outs. Here's the pitch. Strike call, fastball over the inside corner, knee high. One ball, one strike. There's a hard struggle going on out here at Yankee Stadium, as you can well imagine. This is it. Now the 1-1 pitch. Rashi throws just outside for ball two. Almost at that outside corner. Cal Hubbard's got a tremendous responsibility on his shoulders. There haven't been too many kicks at all on his decision so far. He's doing a fine job. Now the 2-1 delivery to Bobby Doerr. Swung on, hit off the head of Branchy, out back to second. Rizzuto is up for the ball, can't hold it though, and Doerr safe. Phil, dashed deep back of second. Got a glove on the ball, but he couldn't come up with it. And it goes as a base hit for Bobby Doerr, and that's the first hit off Branchy. Up comes Al Zarrilla. Little Phil almost came up with a play of the game as he skipped back deep a second. But the ball would not stick in the glove. Now Al Zarrilla steps in, hitting at 280. Here's the pitch. Inside to Al, ball one. Billy Goodman on deck. Yanks one, Red Sox nothing. Fourth inning. Zarrilla grounded out for Rizzuto in the second inning. Nice, he stretches, checks door. Now the pitch. Zarrilla takes outside. Ball two. Branchy having a little concern now that there's a runner on. Two balls, no strikes. Big stretches. Here's the pitch. Strike one call, fastball through there. A 2-1 count on Al Zarrilla. Big Ben set Henry Coleman against Doerr. Here's your pitch. Swung on, it's a fly ball, hits foul down the left field line, it's going to go out of play. Johnson was too rapid, can't get to it, and it's a 2-2 count. Balls, two strikes, two outs, top of the fourth inning. 1-0 New York. Bobby Doerr. In the infield hit, the first hit given up by Razzy. Al Zarrilla at the plate to count 2-2. The left hand hitter. Now pitch is set. Well, there's Zarrilla to stretch. Doerr moved. Here's the pitch. Swung on, line out in left center field. There's the Maggio racing over to try to cut it off. Doerr's round second on his way to third. Here comes a throw quickly in to Coleman. Air runners on first and third. And the batter, Billy Goodman. So the Red Sox with two down here in the top of the fourth inning go to work. Zarrilla's was a hard liner into center. Time's called. Hendricks and Barra and Radke stalk at the mound. Billy Goodman is the batter. Runners on first and third for the Red Sox and two down. Goodman hitting at 298. And now each team has had two hits. And Radke's in trouble for the first time in the ballgame. Now the Red Sox fans have something to holler about. And Radke has to go to work. Doerr on third. Zarrilla on first, two outs to stretch. Here's the pitch. Swung on, foul off, out of play to the left of the plate. Strike one. Goodman hitting at 298. Hit to the Rosen bag. Bobby Doerr on third, Al Zarrilla on first. Pitch all set, Goodman to play. Here's the pitch. Swung on, foul off onto the screen, strike two. Ratchet taking his time. Tense moment in the ball game. They're all tense. American League Pennant, riding on every pitch. Ball over the inside corner.
Goodman strikes out.
Joe leads off. Lindell and Johnson to follow. Joe tripled with two outs in the first inning. Turned out to be wasted. Hitting at 350. Ellis Kinder fires. DeMadge takes a strike right in there. One strike to count on the Clipper. Kinder scoops down low as he goes into the windup. And the pitch is just outside. Ball one, one and one. Outfield, of course, swung around toward left. Al Zarrillo's not as far over into right center as he was previously because twice in this series, the Mads has got an extra base hit into the right field corner. The pitch swung on to drive to deep left center. Dom is going to go back and get it, though. Way out there in deep left center and hauls it in for the out. And DeMadge lines out deep left center to Dom DiMaggio. Brings up Johnny Lindell. He walked in the first inning, right-hand hitter. And we pause very quickly for station identification. WINF New York, 1010 on your dial. Lindell walked in the first, back to right-handed. Hitting 239, 1-0 favor the Yankees, last the fourth inning. Kinder throws, Lindell takes high and inside, ball one. Kinder, after a bit of a shaky start, has been untouchable. He's retired 8 in a row. The right-hander throws, Lindell takes high and inside again, ball two. Kinder's 2-0 pitch to Lindell on its way. John takes high. Ball three. Bill Johnson on deck. Magnificent crowd out here. There have been magnificent crowds at Yankee Stadium all year long. The 3-0 pitch in there for a call strike. Over 2 million people have attended the stadium this year, stadium games. And I think it's a tremendous tribute to New York's finest for the wonderful job they've done in handling the crowds. The 3-1 pitch. Inside, ball four, Lindell walks. Screwball took off inside. Brings up Billy Johnson, who grounded the second last time up. Yes, sir, everybody wearing the police uniform has done a tremendous job around the stadium this year, and I'd like to tip my hat to Inspector Walter C. Harding of the charge of the 11th Division for the great job that he and his men have done this year. Billy Johnson awaits the pitch. Takes outside, ball one. Johnson hitting 247. Couldn't have Jones just hit one in the fourth inning with two on for the Phils, put them back in the ballgame with Brooklyn. Pitch is swung on by Johnson, foul off upstairs. Home run yesterday that kept the Dodgers from clinching the National League pennant. And after they'd gotten off of that 5-0 lead down to three innings, it's Pudd'nhead Jones blasting one with two on last the fourth. Inspector Wallace C. Harding, thanks to him, Captain Harry Brown, Lieutenant Crosby, former Sergeant, now Lieutenant Dick Esau, Sergeant Matt Powers. They've all done great work. The stretch by Kinder. Check of Lindell. The pitch. Johnson takes. Strike two call. That was a curve. Broke over just below the shoulders and over the inside corner. Kinder is pitching cagily. I'd like also to thank Lieutenant Tom Maxwell and his crew, Mike and all the guys, for the great job they do in traffic and handling the tremendous flow in and out of the traffic around the stadium, particularly in these times when the parking lots are all torn up and they're building the new roadway in behind the stadium. It's a rugged. Kinder all set. Lindell off first. Here's your pitch. Billy Johnson takes high and inside. Ball two. If at a time you might have been in quest of information or got caught in a jam and there might have been a harsh word or so as you moved along, it's only because of the millions of people, of the thousands, the hundreds of thousands of people, and the millions too they've had to handle. Here's the pitch. High, ball three. Cards three, Cubs nothing, then of two innings. The last of fourth down at Philadelphia, and the Phils have gotten at least three. Putting Heads Homer with two on, putting Ed Jones home with two on. Got a full count here on Billy Johnson, last of fourth inning. One out, 1-0 New York. Lindell on first base to stretch. Now look. There goes John. The pitch is swung on and missed. Strike three. The throw down is not in time. Lindell on the fall-away slide. Steals second. Tebbett's throw wasn't too good. It was on the second base side, or rather the first base side of the second. And Stevens, although he made a nice play on it, couldn't get John and it's a stolen base. Johnson strikes out. Lindell steals second. Now the batter is Cliff Mapes. Mapes grounded the second in the second inning. Batting at 244. Kinder delivers. Mapes swings and rams one down the first baseline. It's foul. It's just foul. It's just foul. That one wasn't fouled by more than a cap on a bottle of Ballantyne. Man, that was close. Woo. Earl Combs jumped to the front of the dugout, hollered to Birdie. Don't let him give him. Don't give him anything more like that. That would have had one in. Rex Barney has come on to pitch for Brooklyn in the last of the fourth inning, replacing Don Newcomb. One strike to count on Mapes. Lindell on second, two down, fourth inning. And the pitch, low inside. Ball one, 1-1. One to nothing favor the Yankees, last to fourth. Kinder getting ready. Now his pitch, just outside for ball two. 2-1. Kinder pitching very carefully to Mapes. Two balls, one strike. Again, the right-hander's ready. Lindell with the leadoff second. Here's the pitch. Mapes swings and misses. Strike two. Man, he cut hard at that one. Whew. Two balls, two strikes, two out. Last of the fourth inning. A bitter battle. Lindell off second. Kinder takes the stretch. Mapes sets at the plate. Here's the pitch, and Mapes takes just outside for ball three. That's screwball. They're going to put him on. Are they? No. Tebbett stepped aside and pointed. I don't know what he's pointing at. I thought it was strange to put him on the spot like this. All right, here's your payoff pitch. Swing on, there's a drive in the deep center field. Don DiMaggio's backing up, going to get under it, and makes the catch. No runs, no hits, no errors, one left on. The score's down to four innings. The Yankees, one run, two hits, no errors, three left on. Red Sox, no runs, two hits, no errors, and four left on. Rizzuto's game-opening triple and Henrik's infield out gave the Yankees their run. The match tripled, two down, Lindell walked, but Johnson ended the inning because he grounded out. I'd like to thank everybody in the Yankees downtown office, Ann Duran, Betty King, Sylvia Snyder, Terry Harding, John Johnson, Lydia Larrera, Jackie Farrell has done a great job, and Frank Scott, our road secretary, Margaret Regette, Lee McPhail, Gene Martin, Red Patterson has done a tremendous job all year. Teresa Silla, Jack White, and Red Strader, Mel Hine, Bernie Masterson of the football, Yankees and Chet Lane, and Bill McCullough, and Iggy McVeigh, and Bruce Henry, and Johnny Johnson, and of course, our deep appreciation to the directors of the Yankees, Del Webb, Dan Topping, George Weiss, Bob Becker, and Art Friedland. A grand bunch of guys all, and of course to Casey Stengel and his Yankees for giving us a magnificent season. Win or lose, Well, Kurt, here's the fifth inning. And the Yankees lead 1-0. So take on over and tell us what's happened.
Okay, Mel. Bertie Tebbets will lead off. Then it's Ellis Kinder and Don DiMaggio. And Rashi works to Tebbets, and it's inside. Ball one. Bertie put on a little show getting out of the way of the ball. Around the letters and twisted his head out of the way and jumped back. I have some television talk. One ball, no strike. Outfield straight away for Bertie. The pitch is inside the same spot. Ball two. 2-0 now. Bertie batting 266. Popped the second his first time up. Yankees one. Red Sox nothing. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Brilliant pitching duel going on now between Kinder and Rashi. Lindell in left. Joe DiMaggio in center. Mapes in right. All right, get ready with that 2-0 pitch. Right in there for a call strike. 2-1 now.
Kurt, inadvertently omitted the name of one guy I certainly wouldn't want to miss. Been around the stadium as long as the stadium has been, the genial superintendent, Charlie McManus.
Yes, sir. There's a swung on line. Foul down the left field line. 2-2.
We couldn't get along without Charlie McManus.
He does a great job, Mel. Two balls, two strikes. Down on Bertie Tebbets, just lined the inside pitch foul by about 2 feet down the left field line. Rashi was behind him with a 2-0 count. Sun's behind the clouds right now. In a bright, sunshiny afternoon. All morning, too. Slightly cool, but it's another perfect day for baseball. All right, Rashi's ready. Here's his 2-2 pitch. Swung on him, a strike three, a curveball. Brother Joe straight away. Swung on. There's a fly ball lifted out there to Brother Joe. Under. Waiting. And he's got it. Brother Dom flies out to Brother Joe. And that's all for the Red Sox. Top of the fifth inning.
Kinder flies out to Joe DiMaggio. Dom DiMaggio flies out to Joe DiMaggio. Ending the inning.
Red Sox down in order. No runs. No hits. No errors. Nobody left. We're halfway through this climatic ball game. And the score at the end of 4.5 innings of play is the New York Yankees 1 and the Boston Red Sox nothing. What are we doing to help out our teachers in their big job of educating our children? The schools need the help of all of us if they're to do their job as well as we should wish. And it's important to bear that in mind these days because our schools are in a bad way. Enrollment's way up, but facilities are poor and insufficient. Teachers are too few and not all of them good enough. Each one of us can do something, though, to improve our schools by thinking about them, by joining our local parent-teachers association, by meeting and talking with our teachers. We're a grand bunch of people. Yes, it's important for our nation's future that we do everything possible to help our schools do their job. So think about it, won't you, folks? You can do a lot to help. Remember, our students today are the citizens of tomorrow. Last half, the fifth inning now. Yankees out in front, 1-0. Each club has two hits in the game. Gerry Coleman, batting in the number 8 spot for the Yankees, will lead off. Vic Rashi on deck, and it's Bill Rizzuto. Kinder comes in with his pitch, and it's right over there for a call strike. Nothing to one. Coleman batting 275. Now the overhand pitch is a curve. Ball strike two, nothing in two. Coleman bounced out to the pitcher his first time up. Williams in left. Dom DiMaggio in center. Al Zarrillo in right. Pesky at third. Stevens is short. Dorr at second. Goodman at first. Tebbets behind the plate. Kinder dips low out in the mound. Here's his two-strike pitch. Curve just outside. Ellis has got that sinker ball that breaks down out to a right-hander. You hit it in the dirt a lot. Pitched against the Yankees last Monday. Pitched Wednesday in relief, Friday in relief, and he started just a week ago yesterday and beat the Yankees up at Boston. The pitch swung on a ground ball, drilled to short. Stevens on the second hop up with it. Throws to first in time. That was a tricky hop to Vern. It was an off-feet hop that skidded into him. Nice play. One away. Here's Vic Rashi coming out of the Yankee dugout now. Vic gets a beautiful hand from the crowd. Big number 17 moving up there to home plate. Grounded to short, his first time up. 5-4, the Dodgers over the Phillies at the end of four. Cards 3, Cubs nothing at the end of two. The pitch to Rashi is a little low. Broke away from him, ball one. One down, bases clear, Yankees lead here, 1-0. They're batting last half of fifth inning. Outfield straight away for Vic. The pitch is right in there for call strike. 1-1 now. Phil Rizzuto, the first man up in the game, triples. Scored on Tommy Henrich's ground ball. Tommy coming right up behind him, and that's been all the scoring. The overhand pitch, call strike two.
Kurt, the Cardinals got one run the top of third to lead the Cubs 4-0. Cubs batting in the last of third. Brooklyn leading the Phillies 5-4 at the end of four, and Constanti is going in to pitch for Philadelphia in the top of the fifth.
Okay, I guess.
And Simmons now.
Simmons. Strike three, swinging on Rashi. Simmons in there now for the Phillies in the top of the fifth inning. So we want to keep you up to date, up to minute on that National League race. Both races will be decided here in the final day. Vic Rashi was the fourth strikeout victim of Ellis Kinder. Struck out two in the third, one in the fourth, and one here in the fifth inning. Ready to go now. Two down, bases clear. Phil Rizzuto up. Scored the only run of the game. Phil takes the call strike. Kinder moving right along like a machine out there, firing that ball over. Yankees haven't had a hit off him since the first inning. Triple by Rizzuto, triple by DeMars. That's all the Yankees have. Same for the Red Sox. High inside to Phil for ball one. 1-1 now. Two down. The base is clear. Yankees one. The Red Sox nothing. Williams over toward the left field line for Rizzuto. Phil lined his triple right in the left field corner in the first inning. Kinder down with the right arm. And a swung on, hit foul, and back to first up into the stand. Counts one ball, two strikes. Penske at third, Stevens at short. Doar at second, Goodman at first. Devitt's behind the plate. One ball, two strikes to count to Little Phil. Fouled out his last time up in the third inning. Now the pitch by Kinder. Swung on. There's a little fly ball out in the right center. Down to DiMaggio. Digs for it. Can get it. Drops in there for Texas Leaguer. A base hit for Rizzuto. Fly ball in the short right center. Sliced off the bat handle. And that brings up Tommy Henrich now. As Rizzuto gets the first base hit for the Yankees since the first inning. Little Phil's had 2-for-3 now. He was batting 276 before he singled out there in right center. Old reliable, Tommy Henrich coming up. Tommy has batted in the only run of the game on a ground ball to Doar, which allowed Rizzuto to come in and score from third. Tebbets has been out to the mound talking to Kinder. They'll pitch very carefully to Tommy. Two down. Yankees out in front, 1-0. We're in the last half of fifth inning. Goodman is holding against Rizzuto down at first. Tommy's nothing for two in the game. Grounded out and struck out. All right, Kinder ready. Pitch is a pitch out. Tebbets thought he'd be going. Rizzuto and call for a pitch out. Phil wasn't going anywhere. One ball, no strikes. Tebbets thought they might have the hit and run on. So he called for the pitch out, but Phil wasn't going. We'll watch Phil down there for you. Dances off first. Goodman holding against him. Kinder ready, delivers, and it's a call strike to Tommy. Ball one, strike one now. 1-1 to count. Teske, even with the bag at third. Stevens is over toward second. Doar on the edge of the outfield grass. Back deep. Goodman holding against Rizzuto. One ball, one strike. Rizzuto, three-step lead, edges off a little more. Another pitch-out call for by Tebbets, but Phil isn't going. Two balls, one strike now. Second pitch-out to Henrich. Phil stays down there at first. Yankees one, Red Sox nothing. Last of the fifth inning. Don DiMaggio's over in right center and back deep, and Gorilla back deep and right for the left-handed batter Henrich. Phil dances off first. The pitch is swung on. There's a pop foul lifted over toward the Yankee dugout, but out of play as Tebbets ripped off his mask, started backward. It sails into the stands, and the count is 2-2. Rush, Bob Rush has got in the pitch for the Cubs in the top of the fourth inning after the Cubs went scoreless in the last of the third. It's the Cardinals 4, the Cubs nothing at the end of three innings of play.
Smith was the starting pitcher for the Cubs in the game. Howie Paulette still in there for the Cardinals. Two balls, two strikes, two down, Rizzuto at first, Yankees lead 1-0. Last of the fifth inning here. Kinder watching Rizzuto. There goes Phil. The pitch is one on. Here's a pop foul coming back out of
Tommy Henrik walked.
Fountain struck out. Runners on first and second. Two down. The pitch. Swung on. Here's a drive out into left center. Don DiMaggio's over there. Gets in front of it and got it for the third out. That's all for the Yankees in the last half of the fifth inning. As Yogi Berra lines out into left center field. But Don going over there to grab it. So in the last half of the fifth inning, the Yankees had no runs. One hit. Single by Rizzuto, the Texas leaguer out in the right center. No Red Sox errors and two left. And at the end of five innings now, the Yankees one run, three hits, no errors. The Yankees have stranded five. The Red Sox have no runs, two hits, no errors, and the Red Sox have left four. So it's a brilliant pitching duel between Rashi and Kinder, and we're ready to go now to the top of the sixth inning, and I'll turn this microphone back over to Mel Allen.
And we're going to pause briefly for station identification. This Ballantyne Ale and Beer broadcast and telecast, with the broadcast portion coming to you over WINS New York, 1010 on your dial. The Brooklyn Dodgers got two runs in the top half of the fifth inning to lead the Philadelphia Phils by a score of 7-4. Phils coming to bat now in the last half of the fifth. Well, here we go now, the top of the sixth inning and the meat of the Red Sox order coming up. Johnny Teske, Ted Williams, and Vern Stevens. Teske flying to left and line to Rashi, hitting a 307. Here's your pitch. Low, ball one. Stan Musial got a home run in the fourth inning. Nobody on for the Cardinals. Cardinals moving on in front, 5-0. Rashi throws. Teske takes. Strike one call. 1-1. One ball, one strike. Outfield straight away for Teske. Billy Johnson in close at third. Coleman deep at second. Henrik deep at first near the line. Rashi throws. Teske takes just outside. Ball two. 2-1. Top of the sixth inning. 1-0 New York. Now the 2-1 pitch. It's high, ball three, as Teske bluffed a bunt, and it's 3-1. The official paid attendance today, 68,055. 68,055. So Rashi getting behind now on Teske. 3-1. You got Williams and Stevens and Doar. And the 3-1 pitch. Outside, ball four, Teske's on. That's the first time in the ballgame the Red Sox have gotten their leading runner on base. And coming up is the Red Sox power, Williams, Stevens, and Doar. Ted hitting a 343, walked and grounded to second. The shift is on, but Coleman's not out on the grass. He's on the edge of the outfield grass. Rizzuto one stride to the right of second. Johnson doesn't feed off third. Rashi's pitch. Curve is low inside. Ball one. Teske has his lead. Williams takes a strike right in there. 1-1. One ball, one strike. Set's got all room in the world in straightaway center and to the left of it and down the left field line. Lindell over into left center. Got a tremendous shot through shortstop. Henrik holding against Pesky. Nobody out. Sixth inning. Johnny has his lead. The stretch by Rashi. The pitch. Williams swings and lifts a high drive to deep right center field. The match backing up. He's coming in a little bit now. Under it. And he's got it. One away. That one was hit a mile high and out toward the right center field bleachers. DeMadge went back, and the wind blowing in a bit from right field caught it, made it hang, and Joe had to come in a couple of steps for it. Now Vern Stevens steps in, batting at 291. Off the second, grounded to short. Outfield swings around toward left. Infield around toward third. Johnson deep near the line. Rosita over toward the gap. Jerry Coleman in 3-4 steps, two strides to the right of second. Henrik going against Pesky. Vic Reddy has a look. Here's the pitch. Inside, ball one. Slowed up on him in the first pitch. One nothing count on Buster. Stretch by Rashi. Look at first. There's a move to first base, but not in time. We'd like you to thank the fire department for their wonderful cooperation at the stadium all year long. They do a great job here that a lot of people don't even know about. They make things safe and orderly, as well as the police department. Here's your pitch. Outside, ball two. Chief Quinn, Captain Darlington, Lieutenant Rader. Thanks a lot for them. Thanks, too, to the Subway Police. Thanks to everybody. Hacker is going in to pitch for the Cubs in the fourth inning. Cardinals got two in the top of the fourth. It's 6-0. Favor the Cards. Cubs batting in the last of the fourth inning. All right, the 2-0 pitch to Stevens. Swung on, fouled back to the screen. Strike one, 2-1. Johnny Pesky's on first base, one out. Top of the sixth inning, 1-0. Favor the Yankees. Bobby Doerr on deck. Six umpires, Hubbard at the plate, Rommel at first, Barry second, Summers third, Honeychick down the left field line, Hurley down the right field line. Rashi set, checks his runner. Here's the pitch. Steven swings, sends a bouncer out toward Coleman. He's up with it. Steps on second, throws to first, a double play. Vern Stevens hits into the inning-ending double play. Bounding to Coleman near the bag. He grabbed it, steps on second, fired to Henrik. The 191st double play of the year for the Yankees. And the score at the end of 5.5 innings remains the Yankees 1, the Red Sox. Well, we're in the middle of the sixth inning. And the Valentine Bard has this to say. 3:44. Tripled in the first inning, lined out to deep center in the fourth. Ellis Kinder fires. The pitch is high, ball two. 2-1 the count. Boy, I'm just forgetting all the adjectives. Just sitting here, just trying to be as calm as you can. And just reporting the ball game. Two magnificent teams fighting their hearts out. And it's a spectacle. The 2-1 pitch. Swung on, it's a fly ball, hit out into center field. Dom, under it, waiting, and he's got it. One away then, the last sixth inning. And up comes Johnny Lindell, who twice has walked. The man who, with one swipe of his bat yesterday, put the Yankees into contention again. That dramatic two-out, eighth inning homer. John batting at 239. It's 1-0 New York, last of the sixth. Now Ellis Kinder going to work again, delivers. Lindell takes inside, ball one. now your pitch. Right in there for a call strike. One and one. Outfield deep swung way around toward left. Infield shaded ball around toward third. One ball, one strike, one out. 1-0 New York, sixth inning. Kinder fires. Lindell takes strike two called over the outside corner. Left Kinder has been just out of this world since that first inning. Got behind on Rizzuto on the 3-2 pitch and Phil tripled and scored on Hendricks infield out. Since then, the Yanks have had but two hits, a triple by DiMaggio and a single by Rizzuto. There's a pitch low outside, ball two. Two balls, two strikes. One out, last the sixth inning. Kinder taking his time, looking up at the wind, which is blowing out toward left. Looking at the flag to see which way the wind is blowing. Now he's ready for that 2-2 pitch. In it comes, and Lindell takes high for ball three. 3-2. Billy Johnson's on deck. Now the full count. Strike three call over the outside corner. The full count pitch nips that outside corner. That's the fifth strikeout for Kinder. And with two down, up comes Billy Johnson. Johnson hitting at 246. A torrid struggle. Kinder methodically firing away. Gets it in there for a call strike. He has been almost perfection itself. The 36-year-old right-hander comes in now with a pitch that swung on line to the right center for a base hit. Zerilla goes over, cuts it off on two hops, throws on into second to door, and Johnson's on with a single to right center, but with two down. And up comes Cliff Mates, who grounded to second and flied to center. That's the fourth hit off Kinder. Been six in the ball game, two for Boston, four for New York. The last two Yankee hits have come with two outs. Always makes a difference. Not always, but most of the time. Not quite so much pressure on your pitcher. You know he only has to get one man out. So Mates is up there. And the pitch. Swung on. Little roller. Hit down toward third. Kinder races over. Picks it up. Fires. It's a nice play. And he gets the runner for the out. Mates topped the pitch. A little roller down toward third that Kinder fielded brilliantly. And got his man. No runs for New York. One hit. No errors for the Red Sox. One left on for the Yankees. And at the end of six innings, New York one run. Four hits. No errors. Boston no runs. Two hits. No errors. The Yankees have stranded six, the Red Sox four. And Red Sox fans by the thousands stand up here at Yankee Stadium for their seventh inning stretch. And the Red Sox, in the seventh inning, will come up with Bobby Doerr and Al Zerilla and Billy Goodman. Looking now at the Ballantyne three-ring scoreboard again. Chicago at St. Louis in the American League. It's 4-3 in favor of the White Sox. Seaver's had a home in the 7-1 on Bill White pitching for Chicago. Zach Taylor's been using a different pitcher every inning. Garber, Ostrowski, Fannin, Farid, Drews, Kennedy, Poppy, and Embry now in the 8th. They're playing a doubleheader. At Detroit, Lemon for Cleveland, Trucks for Detroit, 1-0 Cleveland, then at 2.5. Washington 2, Philadelphia nothing, then at 6.5, Frisky against White. Kittle came on in the 5th. And in the National League, Pittsburgh beat Cincinnati the first game 4-2, Chambers besting Fox. Cooper had a homer. Raffensperger against Worley in the second game. Reds got one in the first inning. The Cardinals 6, Cubs nothing. Last the 4th, Paulette against Schmitz with late Russian hack in relief, Musial a homer. Dodgers 7, Phils 4. Last the 5th inning, Newcomb relieved by Barney in the 4th. Myers started for the Phils. Roberts, Thompson, Simmons, and Constanti in relief. Pitch 2, door outside, ball 1. Jones in the 4th inning, a home run for the Phils, 2 on. Kennedy against Bond, Giants and Braves. It is 2-1 Braves, last the 8th. All right, Bobby Doerr, hitting at 291. Here's the pitch. Strike one call over the outside corner. 1-1 on Bobby. Slide to right and singled. Back at second. Phil got a glove on the ball but couldn't hold it. One ball, one strike. Top of the seventh inning, 1-0, favor the Yankees. Big crashes into the windup. In comes the pitch. High, very high, ball two. While we're passing out our thanks go to Dr. Sidney Gaynor. He has had probably very little time for his private practice, taking care of all these Yankee injuries throughout the year. Two balls, one strike. Bobby Doerr leading off in the top of the seventh inning. Big crash into the windup. In comes the pitch. Swung on, pop foul, out of play. Coming back behind, Yogi can't get to it. Ball drops right in front of us, and it's a 2-2 count. Dex Houston is throwing out in the bullpen for Boston. Boy, what a ball game. What hangs in the balance? Two balls, two strikes. Door away from the plate. Rashi ready. Here's the pitch. Inside for ball three. Philadelphia Phils got a run the last of fifth, but 7-5 favor the Dodgers over the Phils, 10-5 innings. Now the payoff pitch to Doerr. Swung on, to high pop up, out into short right. Coleman goes out on the grass. He's under it, calls for it. And look out, it's Mace. Mace makes the catch. Hendricks hollered Coleman off of it. Jerry was under it, and he suddenly started running towards second. But Tommy Hendricks was hollering to Coleman, get off of it. One down, and up comes Al Zarrillo.
Zarrillo struck out.
Rashi says to Johnson, watch for the bunt. Just in case, here's your pitch. Swung on, a ground ball hit out to short. Rizzuto is up with it. Throws over to Hendrick in time. The inning is over.
Four runs.
No hits, no errors. Nobody left on. And the seventh inning stretch. And they're roaring. Well, while the fans are out here taking that stretch, it's a mighty good time for you to take a quick trip to the refrigerator for a bottle of Ballantine beer. If you're listening in at your favorite tavern, don't just say one up, but be sure to ask the man for Ballantine. Enjoy the two B's, baseball and Ballantine. As you linger over that sparkling glass of Ballantine beer, as you feel it trickle down your throat, you'll say, ah, oh, man, this is the life. Baseball and Ballantine beer. And while we're on this pleasant subject, folks, I'd like to remind you that it's a smart idea to keep plenty of Ballantine on ice at home at all times, to serve at mealtime, to enjoy it during leisure hours. So at your dealers, be sure to look for the three rings, asking for Ballantine beer. Getting ready for the last of the seventh inning, it'll be Coleman, Rashi, and Rizzuto coming up. Ellis Kinder, out on the mound. The lone run of the game was scored in the first inning when Rizzuto opened with a triple into the left field corner and scored on Hendricks infield out. Now Jerry Coleman awaits the pitch. Takes a strike right in there. That Kinder has, since that first inning, been tremendous. One strike to count. Coleman batting at 274. Coleman bounced out to Kinder and grounded out to short. Pesky in close at third. Outfield straight away. The delivery just outside. Ball one. 1-1. One ball. One strike. Last the seventh inning. Yankees 1. Red Sox nothing. A bitter battle between two great ball clubs. The Pennant at the end of the rainbow. Now the 1-1 pitch to Jerry. Strike two call, a beautiful hook that broke over the outside corner. The Cardinals fail to score in the fifth inning, and it's 6-0 in favor of St. Louis. Cubs batting. The last half of the fifth. Dodgers lead the Phils 7-5. at the end of five. One ball, two strikes. Jerry Coleman choking that bat 3 inches or so. Awaits Kinder's delivery. Here it comes. And Coleman swings and drives on the right side. Don DiMaggio races over, and he's going to get under it and hauls it in. Boy, how that guy can cover ground. He bends over low and races like a greyhound and hauls him in. Dodgers fail to score in the top of the sixth inning. Now, here's Vic Grassi coming up. Kinder going to work on his mound opponent. First pitch is swung on, foul tip, strike one. Rashi took a good cut. Vic hitting at 159. One strike to count. Kinder throws way outside. Ball one, one and one. Phil Rizzuto's on deck. Now the 1-1 pitch. Curve is in there for call. Strike two. One and two. Beautiful sweeping curve. One ball, two strikes. One out. Last the seventh inning. 1-0 New York. Kinder throws. Rashi takes outside. Ball two. 2-2. There is a possibility that this would be Kinder's last inning of pitching. Tebbets and Kinder, first two men up in the eighth inning. McCarthy, May, Derek, Kinder for a pincher. That's just a possibility. The 2-2 pitch, swung on, loop foul back to first, out of play, the ball dropping into the lower seats. The Red Sox will be coming up for the eighth inning, and Joe McCarthy will begin to make his move so that entirely possible Kinder will be taken out for a pinch hitter. Tebbets will be leading off, and then will come after the ninth spot in the order, Dom DiMaggio. Now the 2-2 delivery, and Rashi swings and hits a fly ball out into short right. Al Zarrilla under the ball, and he makes the catch. Two down, and up comes the Scooter. He tripled in the first inning and scored the only run of the game thus far. Fouled out to Tebbets and single to center. Phil batting at 277. What a great year he's had. He has been a spark plug. Two down, Kinder going to work. And his pitch. High and inside to Phil, ball one. Right-hander throws. Phil takes outside for ball two. You know, again we say it's tough, real rough and tough, to see two great clubs like this together where one must lose. The pitch swung on, lined right to Stevens at short for out number three. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. At the end of seven innings, the Yankees one run, four hits, no errors. Six left on. The Red Sox, no runs, two hits, no errors, and four men left on. Well, as we go to the top of the eighth inning, Buddy Tebbets will be leading off. We're going to pause briefly for our station identification. WINS New York, 1010 of your dial. He led the American Association in hitting, and he's ready to move in now to bat for Kinder. He's had one out of four with the Red Sox. Tom Wright, left-hand hitter.
Tebbets grounded out, short, top to first base.
Top of the eighth inning. Bill Ranchy goes to work. Here's the pitch. Outside, ball one. Don DiMaggio's on deck. Billy Johnson in close at third. Big gap in left center in the outfield. Here's your pitch. Low outside, ball two. Now Casey Stengel is trying to move somebody. Casey Stengel trying to move his outfield a little more toward left. 2-0 count on the pinch hitter. Batting for Kinder, top of the eighth inning. Flashes 2-0 pitch. Strike one, it's called a fastball forward through there. Two balls, one strike. Vic ready. And the 2-1 pitch. Strike two, it's called. Two balls, two strikes. One out in the eighth inning. Vic again ready. Into the windup, round comes the arm, the pitch. Swung on, fouled back to the screen. The count holds at 2-2.
Tom Wright is the batter.
Cubs 1 at the end of 5 innings. Dodgers 7, Phils 5 at the end of 5 innings. Yanks 1, Red Sox nothing. 8th inning. One out. Tom Wright pinch hitting for Ellis Kinder. A count of 2-2. Vic Ratchy starts the windup. Around comes the right arm. Here's the pitch. High, ball three. Full count now. 3-2. And that was the big pitch for Ratchy. Vic throws the rubber. All right, ready for the payoff pitch. Here it comes. That's outside. Ball four and right's on. So the Red Sox get Tom Wright on base. Rashi was pretty even with him, 2-2, but lost him. Now you've got Don DiMaggio stepping in and Johnny Pesky to follow. Dom grounded to first, grounded to short, flied to center. And Rashi now has got to bow his neck as you move down to the line. All the Red Sox in front of their dugout. Johnson in close to third. Dom hitting a 308. Here's your pitch. Strike one, it's called. Fastball over the inside corner. Letter high. Man, the tension is just popping. Banta has gone in to pitch for Brooklyn in the sixth. The Red Sox are out there rooting. Rashi gets his sign. Henry collars through Big Summer, played halfway. Now, wait a minute. Yeah, okay. We're ready. Stretch, a check of the runner. Here's the pitch. Inside for ball one, 1-1. Leonard pitching now for the Cubs in the sixth. Both bullpens are working hard. One ball, one strike, one out in the eighth inning. Vic all set. Checks Tom Wright moving off first. The pitch to Dom. Swung on. A bouncer hit out to Rizzuto. He's grabbing it. Runs, steps on second. Fires to first. A double play. Grabbed that one. He said, look out, Jerry. Get away. I'm coming. He ran, stepped on second, and fired to Hemrick for the DP. Well, sir, the good Lord above only knows what's going to happen. Because the Red Sox will come up in the ninth inning with Pesky, with Williams, with Stevens, and if need be, Dorr and Cirilla. They got their power. The Red Sox can be in any better position for a ninth inning onslaught But here we come, the last of the eighth inning, and you know who's coming in for Kinder, don't you? Mel Parnell. And the Yankees will have here in the last of the eighth inning, Henrik, Vera, and DiMaggio. And so the tension is just out of this world as Mel Parnell comes on. Speaking about Mel, I'm still with you.
Yes, sir, you sure are. You know, you got a nice look there in your face. You must be thinking about something nice.
Well, I guess I was at that. I'm supposed to say, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, at round about this time, I get to thinking how nice it would be to have a thick, juicy steak in front of me with French fries on the side and a bottle of Ballantine ale. But I got news for you. I'm not thinking about that right now.
Well,
I got plenty of time to think about that when the game is over.
And I'm supposed to say that's a pretty picture, all right.
It is a pretty picture.
Ballantine ale fits into it just perfect. You know, Mel, it's hard to believe how good Ballantine ale really is with a meal, seriously, until you try it.
Oh, man, everybody knows that. Ballantine ale makes any meal practically a feast. Wonderful. So, friends, next time the meal's on the table, give yourself a treat. Look for the three rings. Call for Ballantine, America's largest selling ale. After the eighth inning, Tommy Henrik leads off. Mel Parnell has come on. Ellis Kinder pitched a magnificent ball. Heartbreaking ball for him for eight innings. Backbreaking for the Yankees. For seven innings. Seven innings of four-hit ball. Walked three and struck out five. Mel Parnell pitches. Henrik swings and fouls it off back to third out of play into the upper deck as he shifted his feet trying to hit the left field. But Kinder went seven innings. He allowed four hits. Walked three and struck out five, gave up only one run, a magnificent performance. Mel Parnell pitches. Henrik swings and sends a long drive to right field. I don't know if it's deep enough or not. It is going, it's gone! Parnell into the windup. Around comes the left arm. Here's the pitch. High and inside to Yogi. Ball one. One and one. Parnell's pitch. Swung on line. Foul down the right field line. And it's a 2-2 count on Vera. Yankees 2, Red Sox nothing. Last the eighth inning. Red Sox have got Pesky, Williams, and Stevens coming up in the top of the ninth. Here's your pitch. Vera swings and lines one into left center field for a base hit. Williams goes over, cuts the ball off. Vera takes his turn, then comes back to first. He singles to left center. And out comes Earl Combs. That's going to be all for Parnell. Mel Parnell comes on, gives up two hits. That's going to be all for the left-hander. And a new pitcher will come out of the bullpen. So Parnell here in the eighth inning. Tex Houston's going to come on. Parnell came on in the eighth, worked the two hitters, a home run and a single. As we told you yesterday, oddly enough, Parnell is more effective against right-hand batters than he is against left-hand batters. The way his pitches take off. His fastball, in other words, takes off into the left-hand batter. So Tex Houston comes on. Coming on from the bullpen for the 29th time this year. He last worked on the 29th, on the 11th of September against Philadelphia. So he's had a long rest. Houston, the first pitch to Joe DiMaggio, then Johnny Lindell. Looks like Johnny Myers hanging around that bat rack. Houston taking his warm-ups. Checking the scoreboard, there's nothing new. At the end of five and a half innings, it's 6-1 in favor of the Cardinals. Cubs batting in the last of six. Philadelphia batting in the last of six. The Dodgers leading them 7-5. Joe Dobson is throwing the bullpen now for Boston. It's 2-0 New York. Last of the eighth inning. Tommy Hendrick greeted Mel Parnell with a home run. And Berra singled. Out he went, and Tex Houston's coming on. How about that White? Didn't that White pitch for Washington today? White and Hill shut out Philadelphia. All right, Joe DiMaggio steps in. He tripled and flied to center twice. Houston looks in and gets his sign. Goodman holding against Berra. Here's the pitch. Strike one, it's called. Houston fired a fast one over the inside corner. Tex thus gives no indication that he'll be wild at all coming out of the bullpen. He's been warming up a lot. Testing near the third baseline. Stretch the pitch. DiMaggio takes strike two, call over the inside corner. Beautiful pitch by Houston. And he got DiMaggio in the hole. No balls, two strikes. Last of the eighth inning. Houston all set. Has a look. The pitch. Outside. Ball one. One and two. That's Texas firing that ball. One ball. Two strikes. And now the right hand of the stretch. Throws. The bag swings and sends the bounder out the door. Door up with it. Over to Stevens for one. Back to first. It is a double play. Joe DiMaggio hits into the double play. Door. To Stevens, to Goodman. The Philadelphia Phillies came up with another pair in the last of the sixth inning, and it's 7-7. Brooklyn and the Phillies tied up at 7-7, 10 of sixth inning. And here's Johnny Lindell. And the pitch to John. Outside. Ball one. Now you're delivering. High. Ball two. Here's the pitch. Swung on. A ground ball hit back through the middle. Out in the center for a base hit. So the double play was a big one. Knocked off a run. And Casey finally saying, why did I have the magical button? Well, I'm just kidding about that. Casey's done a magnificent job. I wouldn't second guess the manager at any time. So I didn't mean to. Just kidding about that. Billy Johnson's being called away from the plate. Is he? Or is Hank Bauer? is being called in from the bullpen. He's going to run to Lindell, I think. Hank Bauer's going to run to Lindell. Give John a big hand, everybody. So Bauer's going to run to Lindell. And Billy Johnson steps in. Down to second, struck out, single to right. Two down, pitch. Outside, ball one. New controls. Back call, right in there. One ball, one strike. Last year, coming 2-0 New York. Two outs. Bob moves off first. Let's see some checks. Throws. Curve is low outside. The ball two. 2-1. Down to 2-1 pitch. Swung on. Foul off. To the right of the plate. Out of play. It'll be up to bat. That's a 2-2 count on Billy. Two balls, two strikes.
Billy Johnson gets the base hit.
Well, Cliff Mason is coming up with two downs. Four hits during this inning, but they've only gotten one run. That was Henry's inning-opening homer. The Mags bounce into a double play to break the back of a potential rally. He may have given Williams an error on bombing that ball, enabling Bauer to go to serve. Two down, Mason's up. Here's the pitch. Outside, ball one. Ground to second, fly to third, bounced out to the pitcher. They flashed it on the board. I don't think they could have given him an error. They didn't do it, did they? Here's your pitch. Swung on, foul off, back to third, out of play into the upper deck. They did give him an error on bobbing the ball. It enables Bauer to take the extra base. It is of no importance at all. Mates is a big guy here. Takes outside, ball through 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Two outs. Foul on third. Johnson on first. Houston ready. Here's the pitch. Swung on and foul back. Strike two. 2-2. Houston ready. Runners lead off first and third. The pitch. High, ball three, almost a wild pitch. Caught over the head, Debbitt. Full count now, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runners on first and third. There goes Johnson, the pitch. Outside, ball four, and they load it up. And the batter is Jerry Coleman. Jerry Coleman steps up, hitting a 274. Bounced out to the pitcher, grounded to short, and fly to center. Tebbets goes out to talk to Houston now. Coleman comes up, goes down the line. Frank Cassetti's going out to talk to him. He's got Bauer on third, Johnson on second. Cliff Mates on first base. Two down. Eighth inning, one run in. And you've got Presti. Williams and Stevens, first three men up in the top of the ninth inning for Boston. All right, Houston going to work. Probably fire that first one right through there. Here's the pitch. Swung on, a little looper in the short right field. Gorilla comes fast, and he can get it. Here comes Bauer. Here comes Johnson. Here comes Mate sticking to the plate. And Mate scores there in the three. And there's a throw to third. And Coleman is out at third for three-run score. And Gorilla is hurting right field. A looping single in the right field. Gorilla tied desperately for the shoestring pen. With a ton of mistakes. Al Gorilla tried desperately for the shoestring pen. And he almost got it. And he didn't quite make it, and he's hurt. And three runs scored. And on the play, Coleman was out at third on the relay. The ball was grabbed by Don DiMaggio in behind Gorilla. It was cut off by Goodman, who fired to Pesci at third, and Bowman was out at third. And Zerilla is hurt, and three runs came in on it, and inning is over. Four runs came in for New York. They lead 5-0 as we go to the top of the ninth inning. And three RBIs for Jerry. Scored as a double. He's out at third. Dom DiMaggio to Goodman to Pesci. Al Zerilla made a magnificent try. What a game guy. And he's up. And listen to hand pouring. New York. Five hits. 1 hour. Nobody left on. And so we come to the top of the ninth inning. Hats off to a great guy, Al Zerilla. He tried sensationally and desperately to touch that ball. And your hats off to him. Now you've got Hank Bauer in left field. Matt stays in center, Mason right. And we're ready now for the top of the ninth inning. And Zerilla getting a hand as he moves off the field. At the end of 6.5 innings in Chicago, it is 6-1 in favor of the Cardinals. Cubs batting in the last of six. The Dodgers are tied up at 7-7. All right, it's top of the ninth inning. And here's Johnny Pesci leading off. Fly to left, line to right and walk. Pitch starts the windup. In comes the pitch. Inside, ball one. One ball, no strike. There's action in the Yankee bullpen. Now big delivered. Strike one is called, 1-1. One ball, one strike. Big hit and set the outfield straight away. Johnson in close to third. Here's the pitch. Swung on, he missed. Strike two as he tried to hit the left field. 1-2 to count now on Pesci. One ball, two strikes. Big stand behind the hill. Nice on the rubber. Right hand is into the windup. Round comes the right arm. Here's the pitch. Curve is just high. Ball two. 2-2. Dodgers fail to score in the top of the seventh inning. Bills are batting in the last of seven. It's 7-7. Now the 2-2 pitch. Low ball three. It's a full count on Pesci. Johnny Pesci's got the count to 3-2. Rankin was ahead of him 1-2. It's all set. The payoff pitch. Swung on. Popped up in the air behind the plate. Yogi's getting under it. He's waiting. And he's got it. And it went away. Went away in the ninth inning. And up comes Ted Williams. Hitting at 343. Buster Stevens on deck. Rankin ready to go to work. Williams walks, round to the second, fly to center. The shift is on. In comes the pitch. Swung on, there's a drive going foul down the right field line, out of play into the upper deck. Strike one. Ninth inning at Yankee Stadium. Yankees 5. The Red Sox, nothing. One ball, one strike, one out. Vic has looked around the outfield. Now he's going to work. Williams sets. In comes the pitch. Inside to Ted for a ball. 2-1. Two balls, one strike, one out. Rashi goes to the rosin bag. There's action still going on out in the Yankee bullpen. Now the 2-1 pitch. And it is low, ball three. 3-1. And Yogi turns to question the decision by Hubbard. A 3-1 count on Williams. That's a 3-1 pitch. Strike two at point to me. Full count now, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Top of the ninth inning. Big ready. Goes Williams. The windup. Around comes the arm. The payoff pitch. Swung on. Grounded foul down the first baseline. The ball comes off to Mates out and right. Flips it over to the right field umpire, Billy. Cardinals fail to score in the seventh inning. They lead the Cubs by a score of 6-1. Bills and Dodgers all tied up 7-7. We'll ask the seventh. The Cardinal win, the Dodger loss will deadlock the National League race and require a 2 out of 3 playoff. All right, Rashi kicks it out in front of the rubber now. Rubs up the cover of the new ball. Taking plenty of time. Now he's ready. Starts the windup. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on. It's caught high in the air, but it's off the line. The plate may go out of play. Back on the screen. And Williams is still alive. Buster Stevens is on deck. Bobby Doerr to follow. End of 7 innings at 6-1. Cardinals leading the Cubs. All right, Rashi again is set for his playoff pitch. Gets the sign and steps off the rubber. Vic wants to think this one over a little bit. Now he's ready. All right. Starts to wind up. Around comes the right arm. In comes the pitch, and it is high, ball four, and Williams walks. Still alive in the ninth inning with one out, and Buster Stevens coming to bat. And the tension holds and mounts ever higher, and it is Stevens who pops the second, grounded to short, and bounced into a double play, starting with Coleman, hitting at 291. And with the power in this Red Sox order, the battle is still racing. Bills failed to score in the seventh inning, at the end of 7 innings, at 7-7. Stevens hitting at 291. Outfield toward left, infield faded around toward third. Rashi takes his stretch, checks his runner. Here's the pitch. It's into the dirt, it gets away from Yogi. Down to second goes Williams. So the possibility of any DP is now obviated. The wild pitch charged to Rashi. Jerry Coleman standing out the hill, talks to Vic. So Vic ready to go to work again on Stephen. One out, one on. Williams on second base, a walk and a wild pitch. Vic has his stretch. Now the pitch. Outside, ball two. Two balls, no strikes. The Red Sox getting something started here. Vic ready for the 2-0 pitch. Here it is. It's low, ball three. 3-0 count now. Three balls, no strikes. Buster Stevens, the batter. Rashi throws, and the pitch is in there for a call strike, 3-1. The 3-1 count. Ratchie again set. Here's the pitch. Strike two call. Full count down, Stevens. It goes with Austin bag. Boy, it's bitter, it's tense, it's tough and rough. Ninth inning, one out. Williams on second base. 3-2 on Buster Stevens. Ratchie has the stretch. Williams the lead. Here's the pitch. Swung on. There's a drive out in the center field, and it's in there for a base hit. Williams round third, holds up as the throw is into Hendrick. Williams held up at third. It's a single to center. Williams playing it safe. Runners on first and third now for the Red Sox in the ninth inning, and Bobby Doerr coming to bat. Fingernail biting time is here. That's the third hit off Ratchie. Doerr slide to right, Singleton slide to right. Bobby batting at 309. Vic has his stretch. Here's the pitch. Swung on. There's a drive to deep right center field. DiMaggio racing way back. The ball is over his head. And there are two runs coming in. And there's Doerr racing the second. He'll go for three. It's a three-base hit for Bobby Doerr, and it's a 5-2 ball game. And only one out as Doerr drove deep over DiMaggio's head in the right center. And the Red Sox are jamming at Yankee Stadium. Now Casey Stengel comes out of the dugout. Mates will go to center, Whitling to left and Bauer to right. Whitling will be in left, Bauer in right, and Mapes in center as the Red Sox have started the jam here in the ninth inning. Ratchie got the first man, but then walked Williams and got behind on Stevens' knee single, and Bobby Doerr crashed a triple to deep right center. So here's Al Zarilla up. Ratchie going to work. In comes the pitch. Swung on. It's a fly ball. Hit out in the right center. Here's Mapes. He's under it. He makes the catch. Doerr tags up, starts for the plate, but then holds up. Look at that throw to the plate, will you? Wow. That makes fired one on the flyer right to Berra. But, of course, Bobby Doerr wasn't going to try. His run doesn't mean anything. It's the men that follow. It's the men that follow that count. There's two down now in the ninth inning. And here's Billy Goodman. Goodman's walk struck out and grounded to short, and Tepes is on deck. And so Ratchie is going to work on Goodman, heading at 296. In comes the pitch. Just outside, ball one. Big delivers. Strike one call, one and one the count. One ball, one strike, two out. Doerr on third. Two runs in for the Red Sox, top of the ninth inning. Yanks 5, Red Sox 2. And Bertie Tebbets on deck. This going to work. In comes the pitch. Just outside for ball two, 2-1. Ratchie's 2-1 pitch to Billy Goodman. Swung on, hit right back through the middle, out over second into center for a base hit. The third run of the inning is in, and the tying run now comes to the plate as Goodman singles to center to score Doerr. That brings up Bertie Tebbets, hitting at 265. And the Red Sox with a stirring ninth-inning rally. And Tebbit is stepping in. And he represents the tying run. Tebbit popped to second, struck out, grounded to third. Rashi pitches. Birdie swings and pops it up in the air. Look out now. Look out now. Henrik says he's got it. Tommy has, and the Yankees win the pennant. And we're going to have a special broadcast for you, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to go downstairs to the clubhouse right now. Kirk, take over.
Okay, Mel's on his way to the clubhouse, Sam. So you who are tuned to your radio, or if you're not there at your radio, get tuned to our broadcast facility, because Mel is on his way down to the clubhouse, and we'll have a special broadcast of the Yankee clubhouse featuring the interviews with the Yankee ball players. So the Yankees have won the 1949 American League pennant, and Vic Rashi was robbed of the shutout in the ninth inning, but he won the big ball game that the Yankees had to have for his 21st win. And Casey Stengel stayed in there with Vic when they were starting the hitting. Vic had pitched a great ball game, a two-hitter until the ninth inning, but Casey decided to leave him in there. He didn't derrick him. Even when the Red Sox came up with a single, a triple, another single, and Tebbit flying out to Henrik in the ball game. So in the top of the ninth, the Red Sox, and once again, stay tuned now. We'll have a special broadcast from the clubhouse. However, I'll keep the air until Mel gets down there and then turn it over to him down the clubhouse. We'll give you the highlights of the ball game here in just a moment. So the Red Sox have three runs, three hits, no errors, and the Red Sox lead one. So here are your final totals now of the ball game. Your final totals, Yankees 5 runs, 9 hits, no errors, and the Yankees lead 6. 5 runs, 9 hits, no errors, 6 left for the Yankees. The Red Sox had 3 runs, all in the ninth inning. 5 hits in the ball game, 3 of them came in the ninth inning. 1 error, Williams bobbled a drive out in left field, allowing Bauer to take an extra base, and the Red Sox left 5. I want to make this announcement in just a moment. Here's a special announcement. $4 standing room tickets are on sale. Are on sale here at Yankee Stadium and at the downtown ticket office, 518 Fifth Avenue. $4 standing room tickets are now on sale. That's for the World Series, and the World Series, unless the National League is tied up, will open here in New York on Wednesday. But they still go on sale, of course, starting tomorrow morning. You can buy them here at Yankee Stadium or at the downtown ticket office, 518 Fifth Avenue. Well, all we can say is that a club won the pennant probably more richly deserved than any team in the history of baseball. And Vic Rashi, coming through, hurled the Yankees to the big ball game on the last day of the season. They won 154 games before we decided, and the Yankees, coming from behind with 70 injuries, a storybook finish yesterday after trailing 4-0, led all the way in this ball game. Rizzuto, the first man up, scored after tripling when Henrik bounced out. It was 1-0 after 7 innings. Kinder, Ellis Kinder, the loser, but deserves a lot of credit. What a great ball game he pitched. He went 7 innings, gave up only 1 run, but then was lifted for a pinch hitter. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're up here in our booth now, and in just a moment, I'm going to turn you over to Mel Allen down in the clubhouse, who has a special broadcast for you, for those that are listening to our broadcast facility. Valentine Ale and Beer has been your host. Your host all season. On behalf of Valentine Ale and Beer, we really hope that you've enjoyed the season as much as we've enjoyed bringing it to you.
Hello there, everybody. We're down here. We're down here in the clubhouse, ladies and gentlemen. I want Casey Stengel to say a word after that terrific victory. Casey, how do you feel, buddy?
I never felt so great in all my life. This is the greatest thing that ever happened to me. since I was born. I want to say one thing. Every one of those ball players are the ones that put me over. And just think, they pay me to have those boys put me over. Thanks one and all. I hope you've enjoyed this year's season. And if you are as interested in the next series as we will be, thank you.
Thanks ever so much, Casey. And here's the guy who gave his all out of a sick bed the last 2 days and did a tremendous job, Joe DiMaggio. Joe, you've been in many worlds.
Well, you know, I made my speech yesterday, and that still goes. This is the gamest, fightingest bunch of guys I'd ever played ball with, and it certainly gives me a lot of satisfaction to be with such a gang as this gang right here. There's no more deserving. I think Lady Luck finally stuck with us for 24 hours.
Lady Luck stuck with us for 24 hours. Thanks a lot, Joe. I want to get Phil Rizzuto. Hey, Phil. In the spark. Hey, Phil. Hey, Phil. Phil Rizzuto. Hey, Phil, you and Tommy, come here. Here's Phil Rizzuto, the real spark plug of the team. Phil, you and Tommy Hendricks are both in line for the most valuable player award. You did a terrific job. I don't know which one of you might get. I hope one of you do, but whichever, I'd like to give you
listen,
a poll award.
Just give it to the whole team, now. No one guy ever won this pennant for us. Casey and the whole team.
25 and how about you, Tommy Hendricks? Tommy, that home run, the eighth inning was sensational.
Well, I got to keep up. Just like Phil said, yeah. The greatest ball club ever put together for spirit.
Well, that's wonderful. Thank you very much, Tommy. And Phil Rizzuto. And Frank Scott's making an announcement here now about World Series tickets. Here's Billy Johnson. Billy, how do you feel, buddy?
I don't know what to say, Mel. I'm so excited I haven't got words to say over the microphone.
Okay. And here's the guy, Ralph Hout. Well, especially out in home or not,
he was out.
It's wonderful. Thank you very much. And here's a guy who has played sensational ball all year at second base. That was a spark plug today, Jerry Coleman. Jerry, how do you feel?
I'm standing back and all excited.
It was really wonderful, though, Mel. It was the biggest thrill I ever had in my life.
But as a game ball club, all the way to the magnificent job. Hey, Yogi, come here. Yogi, come here. How are you?
Oh, fine. If he had to win 1-0, he would have done it, Mel. He had great stuff to do.
He really did?
Oh, boy.
And you were playing that best for you.
Oh, just right.
Well, that's wonderful. Yeah, here's the guy. How about that? Cliff Mapes. Here's Cliff Mapes who played. And, Cliff, that throw into the ninth inning, of course, got a big rise out of the crowd. Just ain't something. We're all excited.
Well, it's just like a good dream. That's all I can say.
Well,
what a dream.
Well, hey, here's Johnny Lindell. And but for the big swipe of his bat in the eighth inning yesterday, the Yankees might not have been able to win it today. Johnny Lindell.
We're pretty lucky now. It's an awful hard struggle. That home run didn't mean anything. We couldn't win today.
That's well. Thanks a lot. And here's the chief. Allie Reynolds. Allie, a wonderful season.
Oh, that was a close one, Mel.
They tell me you in the bullpen today.
I think I threw about half of it myself.
Well, that's good. Congratulations, Allie.
Thank you.
And here, Charlie Silvera and Gus Niehaus. Come here, boys. Say a word, will you, Silvera?
Well, how about that one?
Well, how about that one? Yes,
took a San Francisco boy to do it. You can say that.
Gus,
I'd just like to send everyone in Birmingham hello on our call tonight, and I'll have all those tickets for you.
Well, who's the guy who packs them up all year long?
That's Jackie Farrell helping us out here. Gus Niehaus, he had a rugged year, but he paid off, didn't he, Gus?
Gus Mouth, you mean, huh?
Gus Mouth. I'm excited myself. Gus Mouth.
I've never been so happy in my life. I still can't believe it.
Well, hey, how about old song, Tommy? How about old song? Come on, what do you say? How about a little song? Tommy Hendricks, you lead it off. Have a little song here. Watch out.
Come on, sweetheart,
Mr. Million.
Yeah. Let me get my mic out of the way. Yeah.
Go right ahead. Here's Del Webb, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Del Webb, corner of the Yankees.
Mr. Webb, how do you feel?
Well, I feel all right.
Wonderful.
Magnificent, wasn't it?
I don't know what I can say.
What do you think of that?
We do know that. Henry, the road guy.
Aren't they terrific?
Poor Joe DiMaggio out there.
Can't hardly stand up.
Here's this Yogi.
Yeah, and Yogi are. Here's the guy that did a wonderful job with those pitchers. And it was his boy that won the pennant today. So Jim had him out there in Portland. When he was manager of Portland, he brought Lassie along and prepared him for the Yankees. And I know Jim is feeling especially proud right now.
Well, I tell you, Mel, I'm as happy as I've ever been in my life. I wanted to win this pennant this year above anything I've ever wanted in baseball. In fact, if there's no other way for us to win, I'd give somebody my truck to take it for free. That's how bad I wanted to win it, didn't I? When Rassi pitches, I'd suffer with him along with the other fellas, but I don't know, I have a soft spot in my heart for him. And he did a great job. In fact, it was just perfect. If you're leading pitcher, finished the season and
finished
the
benefit. Well, Jim, I know that he must have had it today.
Yes, he did. He's
been
a wonderful
ball game. I'm glad to hear that. Thanks a million.
What's that,
Sergeant? Yeah. Yeah, well, we had it. I had all the names on the air today, Sergeant. Yes, sir. Sergeant Winter. Thank you very much. I want to get George Weiss. George Price, the Yankees general manager, vice president, who really suffered through a season, and he's done a magnificent job at this first pennant in his capacity. It's your first major league pennant, George.
First major league pennant.
I know you got
I'm
really
excited to talk.
Well, congratulations, George, and I'm excited myself. The Yankees. I just want to shake your hand, and say it was a wonderful fight and a great club. And Commander
Rabbit, what
did you see
this
team a lot this year?
I've seen them all year long, and I never thought for a minute they were going to be defeated, but chance today.
And here is Frank Graham, brilliant columnist in the New York Journal America.
There isn't very much I can say. Mel was really terrific. I've never seen anything quite like his arm of intelligent baseball.
Thanks a lot, Frank. And they're taking pictures right and left. Here's Lou Burton over here. Buck O'Neill, how about saying a word? Right, he's got out of my line, fellas. Buck O'Neill.
Well, I spent 20 years with the Yankees traveling with them. I think this is the greatest and the most courageous team that I've ever seen. They won the greatest pennant in all the history of baseball. I traveled with their manager from Boston to Manila, and I say he's one of the greatest of all time. Three cheers for the Yankees, and three cheers for Casey Stengel.
Thanks a lot, Buck. Here's Jim McCulley. Is there any news, Jim?
Hello, fans. I just witnessed the Yankees winning their 1949 pennant, and I say that the one man that did the most was Joe DiMaggio. His inspiration was the most terrific thing I've ever seen in my life in baseball.
And now, I just got to take this mic for a minute. Here's Joe McCarthy's just come in. Show me the thing over here. Joe McCarthy and Casey Stengel. And pictures are being taken. And they're shaking each other's hands. And boy, they're just hugging one another. And it's terrific. Casey and Joe McCarthy shaking hands. And Joe just said to Casey, you did a heck of a job. You did a job. And there's a magnificent picture right here. Joe McCarthy and Casey Stengel with their arms around one another. And great sportsmen both. No, I won't. And Joe, would you just say a word? The people love you. Joe, they love you. You know, they love you in New York.
Well, I want to congratulate Casey Stengel. I think he's done a wonderful job this summer in handling the Yankees. And it's too bad that we both couldn't win, but it's one of those things. And Casey, congratulations again, and good luck in the series.
Thank you, Joe. I think you win so many, it's nice of you to allow me to have one.
That's very nice. Joe McCarthy and Casey Stengel there. And
Casey's parting remark is a good one. Said, you won so many, it's nice to let me have one. And so the clubhouse here is pandemonium, is. That's the expression they all use. Here's Hi Goldberg from over at New York. Hi, you've been following this team a lot.
I can't talk, Mel. It was so exciting. It was the most exciting ball. Last two games, well, anyway, it was the exciting ball games that we've ever seen. They couldn't make it any closer. 1-0 up to the ninth inning.
Well,
enough to leave you with heart failure every day.
Here's Eddie Lopez. I didn't get you on the air a while ago, Steady Eddie. Are you steady right now?
I am right now, Alan. It's really a great thrill to win a pennant, and the way we did it today, and I mean, it was a battle all the way. I mean, now we know we've earned it.
How much did you work in the bullpen today?
Well, to tell you the truth, I didn't work at all.
You didn't work too hard. You're getting ready for the series.
That's right.
Thanks a lot, Eddie. You know, the way you handle the microphone, I hope you get that sports program this winter down.
Thank you, man.
Talking about. Thanks a lot, Eddie. Here's Frank Kniff. Brilliant college of the Journal American.
Thank you, Mel.
Frank.
It's a wonderful team here. This team certainly deserves it. And you know, one thing about this team, I think they've had more sports writers rooting for them than any team before, don't you think so?
You're right.
They've really got everybody's heart and mind at it. So a great team run.
Thanks a lot, Frank. Irish D-backer of the Morning Telegraph. Sorry, the World Telegraph. The Morning Telegraph, excuse me, Aaron.
Well, they all agree this was a tough series. I guess it's so. The two old timers, Bill Dickey and Joe DiMaggio, said they never played a tougher one. Now, let's hope they get the World Series.
I don't know how the Dodgers are coming out right now, but here's Ray Howard, photographer. Wait just a minute. I'll get that from you a minute. Here's Ray Howard of the Associated Press, photographer. Ray, what do you think of it?
Oh, I think it was the greatest game that Rashi ever pitched. And in here in the dressing room is the greatest place to make pictures, and we'll see them in tomorrow's papers by the Associated Press. Thank you very much.
Press plug for the Associated Press. Louis, come in with international news. I'm too excited to name
Harvey Sharp, an international news caller, pal.
You guys do a great job, and we did want you to say hello. Here's Louis Efrat of the New York Times. Lou, what was the score of the Dodger game last you heard?
Well, just about 20 seconds ago, I heard it was 7-7 going into the 10th inning.
7-7 going into the 10th.
That's right.
And the Cardinals already won their game, or is that not over
yet? No, they have scored two more in the top of the ninth. That gives them a pretty safe lead, Mel.
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot, Lou. What do you think of the Yankees?
I think just what you think, Mel. We love them.
Well, thanks a lot, Lou. I want to get my line. Excuse me just a minute. Thank you, sir. I don't know how many of these players like you that I haven't had on, and those that Lenny Lewin of the Daily Mirror.
I want to coin a phrase for you, Mel. Well, how about that?
That's about the size of it, if you were believing.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, this has been one of the wildest finishes I've ever seen this last week. I don't think the ball players believe what they say.
I don't believe they do either. Here's a guy I know that's happy about it all, Hank Bauer.
Thank you, Mel. What a wedding present.
Wow.
You're going to get married?
3 weeks from yesterday.
Oh, that's sensational. That's wonderful. Well, I'm just moving around. And, Vic, I haven't had you say a word. Here's the guy, ladies and gentlemen, that pitched the Yankees to the Pennant today with his 21st victory, Vic Ranky.
Thank you, Mel. It's a real pleasure to win this one. It's the best victory I've ever won. Number one of 49.
That's well. Thank you very much, Vic, and I'm so happy for you. And here's old Tommy Burns. Come here, Tommy. What do you say, Mel? What a day, huh? What a day. The Dodgers just scored in the 10th inning. They're still at bat. And, Tommy, thanks a lot for saying hello. Billy, did you say hello a while ago? I've been going out. Did you? Thanks a lot. And here's Joe Page. Smokey Joe, who really went out and busted it off yesterday to set it up for today.
How you doing, Mel?
Fine. How you doing,
Joe? Oh, boy, right now, wonderful.
That's it, well.
There's Valentine's, too.
Valentine's Ale and Beer. Okay. Freddie Sanford, how about a word?
Boy, this is the happiest day of my life, I'll guarantee you.
I know it is, Fred, and everybody feels that way. Gene, did you say hello, Gene Woodling?
Great to be a Yankee, Mel. That's all I can say. Great to be a Yankee.
Thanks ever so much. Well, folks, that's just about the size of it. Everybody was dashing around. Hey, it's John. Johnny, here's Johnny Mize.
Hello, everybody. What do you want me to say?
How you feel right now?
Huh?
Anything.
I can't talk for a week, can I?
Thank you. Talk for a week. Just say hello.
Well, that's where you feel.
Thanks, John. And Bobby Brown.
Bobby, how are you?
Boy, you just wouldn't believe anybody could beat him, Mel.
I got to get
him. Well, brother, you sure did a magnificent job through that stretch all year long to help him do it. And I hope you have as much success in this World Series as you had 1 or 2 years ago.
I hope so, too, Mel.
Thanks ever so much. As we stand around here, I want to have Bert Gumpert of the New York Post, who follows the Yankees, have a word here.
Well, I've just seen a finish of a pennant for the McGamest and most courageous baseball club I've ever seen. It isn't a great club technically, but my God, how they make up for any deficiencies by their amazing spirit and courage. Winning yesterday again today was something to be out of this world, and I have been around baseball for many years. I've never been more impressed in my life.
Bert, thank you. What's this fellow's name from Akron over here? I can't think. Yeah, but don't let him. I mean, I know him. I can't think of it. I'd like Tom Galley over here, who used to be associated with the Yankees, now with Dumont Television, say a word.
Mel, I'm speechless. It was terrific.
It really was, wasn't it?
How do you like that,
though? How about that? And here's Mr. Friedland, associated with the Yankees in the legal capacity. And because I said that, he's not going to make a long speech, but I know he wants to express himself.
Well, hardly anything anybody can say at this time. This celebration down here is simply wonderful. The boys deserve everything. Greatest game that I've ever seen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Freeman. Red! There was something, wasn't it? I guess we got about everybody, except Mr. Webb's father. Here's Mr. Webb's father, owner of the Yankees. How do you like that? Your son did a pretty good job, didn't he?
Yeah. What do we know about baseball? It's still the Yankees.
Thank you very much, sir. That's swell of you. I guess that's about all, friends. We could keep going around and around here all evening. But we've just been in the clubhouse here with a tremendous celebration going on as the Yankees won the pennant. Excuse me, would you mind my wire here? I want to see if... Hey, Ed. Eddie Romo. Hey, stop the umpire for a minute, will you? Hey, Patterson. Hey, Red Patterson.
What?
I wanted to get the umpires off. Charlie McManus. Just listen, superintendent of the stadium, how do you feel, Charlie?
Never better in all my years there.
Thank you very much. Bill Skiff of the Yankee organization. And the manager of New York and Kansas City, Bill.
Well, hello, fans. It was the greatest finish I've seen in many a year.
Well, thanks a lot. I sure appreciate that. Hey, Hugh Casey. Hey, Casey, come here just a minute. Pardon me just for a minute. You know, here's the situation developing. Hugh. Are you eligible for the series? I mean, my excitement.
No, I'm not, Mel. I came in 5 days too late.
Yes, too bad. Just going to say, with the Dodgers maybe getting in, you might have had the tables turned. I know that you pitched for the Dodgers against the Yankees in the 41 World Series.
I sure wish I was eligible to pitch against them again because I think I could beat them.
Then you beat the Dodgers.
That's right, if they needed me.
Well, you, what do you think of this ball club?
Well, to me, it's one of the greatest ball clubs I've ever been on. It's spirit, the will to win. It's back when we had those great ball clubs in Brooklyn. The same way, we were never beat, we went right down to the last state. Just like this ball club. They were just confident they were going to beat them the last two days of the season. And I walked in the clubhouse this morning, and everybody looked like we were already headed sink. Well, that's how happy they were.
Well, thank you very much. Here's a good friend of mine, Bill. Bill Corum, ladies and gentlemen, no more need be said. Bill?
Well, Mel, was just a great finish, that's all.
It
couldn't have been better, and I'm so happy for Casey and Joe and all the Yankees, and for all of New York. I think it was a great victory. But I must also say that I feel very sorry for Joe McCarthy in the sense, even though I was rooting for the Yankees. A great manager, did a great job, and hasn't had any luck in these playoffs. In other words, in photo finishes, Mel, Joe hasn't been too lucky.
Right.
But he's still a great manager and a great fella. And, of course, Casey did an indomitable job with the Yankees this season and they themselves. And I'm just going over now to congratulate Casey, old Kansas City boy. And you did a great job, too, Mel, and I know you will in the World Series.
Bill, I'm just going to say,
The payoff was when Joe McCarthy walked over, and he and Casey just put their arms around one another. It was a wonderful thing. And they both sort of commiserated with one another and all like that. And finally, Casey's parting shot to him was, well, Joe, he said, all I can say is, you have won so many. Thanks for allowing me to have one.
That's great. That's baseball, yeah. And it was perfect.
That was outside.
And a great finish for baseball. And
the
way all these games are finishing makes baseball so wonderful.
Thanks a lot, Bill. Although this is not a fight, but it's pandemonium, here's Don Dunphy, who just walked in, and he and Bill Corum always team up. Here's Don. Don, how about it?
Oh, Mel, how about it? What can I say? I'm speechless.
It was a terrific
the greatest game I ever saw.
It sure was.
Oh, it certainly was. Mel, go ahead.
I
can't
Don.
Say a word.
Okay. Here's Mr. Del Webb's brother. I introduced you to his father a moment ago. How do you feel?
Well, I couldn't be any happier, Mel. I think we won our great ball game. I think we won it the hard way. We won it by hitting that ball. We had some line drives caught on us. I think we outplayed them today. I think we deserve to win. And I want to say, in my estimation, we have the greatest Yankee ball club of all time. With 70 injuries, they couldn't put us out.
Thanks ever so much. Bill Dickey. You've been on many a Yankee punt winner, and we can't leave you out of this one.
Mel, ain't that wonderful?
That's just terrific.
What is it that you say?
How about that? How about that is right. Well, thanks a lot for you, Bill. I know you've been on many great Yankee teams, but this is one that had the heart of a lion.
Mel, I got more kick out of this team winning this year than anyone that I ever was with.
There's one thing I want to say. You acted like you knew it was going to happen all the time.
I do.
Thank you very much. Excuse me. Well, folks, we're going to wind up this broadcast series from here. And we tried to get as many as we could on our microphones to say hello to you. And it's just been wonderful. Ed, would you like to say a word? Ed Pitcher of the Yankees organization.
I tried to pull a plug out. I saw it, but I hope I'm still on.
I hope you're still on, too. Thanks a million. And thanks to all of you folks for listening in. And now, if they're ready, back in the studios, this is Mel Allen, who with Kurt Gowdy all year has been bringing you the Yankee baseball broadcast. And I want to take just this moment, which I did not have the opportunity to do upstairs, of thanking each and every one of you for being so wonderful to all of us all during the year. It's been a tremendous season. It was a great ball club that lost the pennant, the Boston Red Sox, a magnificent team, one that your hearts went out to in defeat. Joe McCarthy, a good personal friend of mine, as are all the Boston Red Sox players. And to the New York Yankees, as fighting, as game a club as ever I've seen, in the face of all odds coming on. And if in the course of the season we have somehow aggravated any of you folks, please know that it was unintentional. It's always been our desire to bring you the game as we saw it, naturally, broadcasting with our team and living with them day after day. And in a season like this, you'd always get a little more excited for the home team, but never at any time did we ever minimize anything the opposition ever did. It's a wonderful...